Hey guys, I'm just waiting for people to come home. Prophet, God bless you, man of God, Prophet Ezekiel, how are you? How are you? God bless you. For those who are coming on, let's double tap shed alive, amen. So I just have a word from the Holy Spirit, and I just wanted to come on quickly, however long the Lord takes to minister. Good sister, how are you doing too? Praise the Lord. All is well with my soul. Thank you. I am very well. God is moving powerfully in the body. Amen. And it's a bit cold here and hot here. So I'm just having a slushy. Hey Jack, how are you, brother? God bless you. So let's double tap share the live, brothers and sisters. Blessings, agape love, God bless you. Amen, glory be to God. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Hello, Helen, God bless you. I'm sure you guys are aware that we are in crazy times, right? We know that we're in some crazy times, and I don't know about you guys, but there's a massive spiritual warfare happening in the body of Christ, and the devil is out to wear the saints, isn't he? Lord. So we'll just keep tapping and share the live, guys. I don't know if I can tap and share the live, but anyways, I can definitely tap and share the live. But we'll open up in prayer, and then we're gonna minister about the Lord. I'm very well, Kiki. Hope you're well. All right, thank you, God. Let's make this sharp and just get off here. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Father. Lord, we just come humbly right now, Lord, in a heart posture of humility. Father, whatever we're carrying, I pray every soul under my voice would lay it at your feet now, in the name of Jesus. I pray, Holy Spirit, that you come and minister to every one of us. I pray that you come and minister to your children right now in the name of Jesus. Lord, we welcome the seven spirits of God. We welcome you, we honor you, and we engage with every one of you. We call forth wisdom, knowledge, counsel, understanding the fear of the Lord, the power of your might and the spirit of the Lord. We welcome every one of you. We ask that you come and minister to every soul under my voice right now in the name of Jesus. We welcome the clouds of witnesses that encompasses around us in Hebrews 12. We pray, Holy Spirit, that you just come and have your way with us. May we decrease so you can increase in the name of Jesus. And every soul under my voice, Lord, every sick soul under my voice, Lord God, I just decree and declare life over them right now. I decree and declare life into them right now, into their wells, oh God, into their womb, oh God, into their minds, oh God, into their bodies, oh God. I decree and declare life over them. Where the devil comes to steal, kill, and destroy, Jesus, you come to give life and life in abundance. And I just speak life over every person under my voice. I speak life over you right now in the name of Jesus. I just detach you from every word curse that's been spoken over you, ignorantly or blindly, that you have received or you have spoken over yourself in the name of Jesus. I command any heaviness right now under the souls and the voice under the souls under my voice. I command every heaviness to be lifted off right now in the name of Jesus. I just clothe you right now with the garment of praise. May worship arise in your altars right now in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Father, we pray for a fresh baptism of the Holy Ghost upon us right now, like Pentecost. Lord, we pray for a fresh baptism of fire upon us right now, Lord God, that you would come and purge us. Purge us, oh God. Purge us, oh God, in the name of Jesus, that you remove any dross, any chaff right now in Jesus' mighty name. I pray that the spirit of repentance would come and minister to us right now, Father. Anywhere that we need to repent, oh God. Anywhere that we do not have clean hands or a pure heart, oh God. Father, I pray right now, Holy Spirit, that you would bring anything that's in the darkness to light now in the name of Jesus. So Lord, Holy Spirit, come and judge us. Holy Spirit, come and pour out your spirit upon us. Come and judge us with your love, Father. Let your love consume us, for you are the consuming fire. And I pray that your love would melt away every deception, every lie of the devil over their minds right now, in the name of Jesus. Father, we give you glory. God, we give you praise. And Lord, we give you honor. We pray that you would be magnified. We pray that you would be glorified in this life right now, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Ooh, I just rebuke every confusion now. I rebuke every spirit of confusion. I speak clarity. I speak sound mind over you right now. Sound mind in the name of Jesus. I drive out any fear in every person under my voice in the name of Jesus. Perfect love casts out all fear. And I drive out any fear right now in the name of Jesus. For God has not given us the spirit of fear, but of power, love, and sound mind. And I release that over you right now. I release that over the airways right now in the name of Jesus. I thank you, God, that I'm in you, you're in me, we are one, oh God. And I thank you, Father, that our weapons are not carnal but mighty through you, God, who pulls down the strongholds in the name of Jesus. So I pull down all strongholds of the mind right now. Everything that's exalting itself above the knowledge of God must come down and bow at the feet of Jesus Christ in Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Breathe afresh upon us right now. Yes, Lord. We need a fresh wind, a fragrance of heaven. Pour your spirit out. Pour your spirit out. Hallelujah. A holy anointing. The power of your presence, pour your spirit out. Pour your spirit out. We need a fresh wind, a fragrance of heaven. Pour your spirit out. Pour your spirit out. Come on, guys, worship with me. A holy anointing. The power of your presence, pour your spirit out. pour your spirit out. Let all the redeemed prophesy and sing. We can hear the wind. It's blowing. Move upon our praise. Sons and daughters, sing. We can hear the wind. It's blowing. We need a fresh wind. Yes, we do, Jesus. A fragrance of heaven. Pour your spirit out. A holy anointing, yeah. The power of your presence. Pour your spirit out. Hallelujah. Whew. Come on, Holy Ghost. Come and minister to your people. Hallelujah. How great is our God? Sing with me, how great is our God, and all will see how great is our God. If you haven't worshipped, worship Him. How great is our God. Sing with me, how great is our God, and all will see how great is our God. Sing it with me. You're the name above all names. You are worthy of all praise. Hello, Bill. And my heart will sing, how great is our God. There is none like you, no one else. No one else can touch my heart like you do. I could search the world eternity long and find there is none like you. Hallelujah. Amen, guys. There is none like the holy God that we serve. Amen. Thank you, Father, that you've prepared the hearts of your people to receive your word, Lord. And I pray, God, that let it fall on good ground. Lord, anywhere that there's any thorn, rocks, Father, I pray that Holy Spirit, angels, that you would come and remove it in the name of Jesus, that you would come and divide the Red Sea in this situation, in their situation, in the name of Jesus. So, Father, I just bless every soul under my voice right now. I pray, God, that blessings would fall upon them, Lord. Whatever situation they're facing, Lord, I pray that you give them more grace in Jesus' name. Amen. How are we going, guys? Let's double tap, share the live. Amen. Where's all the people? It's like 4:14 here. So, I want to come on here. The Lord really wants me to come and minister to you all. Because I don't know what you're going through. But I know that you're in times of tribulations. I know that you're in times of trials. I know that you're in hard yakka, like you're in hard times right now. But this is a scripture that I really want to minister to your heart. And so if you guys want to turn with me, and if any one of my lovely brothers or sisters can put this up, we're going to read from 1 John 2, 24. Amen? 1 John 2, 24. And I'm going to read from this, okay? So anyone got their Bibles? Let's open up the Word together. Okay. Let. Let that there abide in you, which you have heard from the beginning. If that which you have heard from the beginning shall remain in you. Come on, Holy Spirit, minister to us. You also shall continue in the Son and in the Father. And this is the promise, brothers and sisters, that He has promised us eternal life. And I'm not just talking about you die and then you go to heaven. That is a false doctrine. That's doctrine of devils. I'm talking about now you have eternal life on earth as it is in heaven. 26. Thank you so much, Remy. God bless you. These things have I written unto you concerning them that seduce you. Now, I really want you guys to get this. And there are seducing spirits. There's antichrist spirits already running amok in the church, running amok in your home, running amok in the world. The devil is having a field day. 27. But the anointing, now this is the word that I really want you guys to be embedded in your heart. I really want you to hear by the Spirit of the Lord. But the anointing which you have received of Him abideth in you. And you need not any man, not any man. Now, if I could highlight what man means. Man represents soul. You don't need a soul to teach you, because who is the teacher? The Holy Spirit is the teacher. Amen? So you don't need any man to teach you. If anything, as I hear the Father saying, brothers and sisters, we should have been taught by the Holy Spirit from the beginning. Are you catching what I'm saying? We should have been taught by the Holy Spirit from the beginning. Because now we have Jesus to teach us all over again, because recognizing the Holy Spirit needs to teach us all over again, because we have not been taught by Jesus Christ. So that means our foundations haven't been founded in Christ. It's been founded in religion. It's been founded in theology. It's been founded in traditions of man. It's been found in you being deceived by man. And I'm here to tell you, if you have received Jesus as your Lord and Savior, you do not need to turn to man to teach you. As the Father was just ministering to me just before, literally like a second, we should not be taught by one another, but we should be bearing witness to one another, because we should be catching. Now hear what I'm saying. We should be catching what Mercedes is saying. We should be catching what Nancy is saying. We should be catching what Chester is saying. We should be catching what, do you know what I mean? Lexi is saying. We should be catching it, because Revelations is not taught, brothers and sisters. It's caught. So we shouldn't even be, there shouldn't even be anyone teaching. It's the Holy Spirit that teaches. Does that make sense? So I'm here to minister to you, brothers and sisters, that if you have received Jesus as your Lord and Savior, then you have the anointing in you to teach yourself. You don't need an apostle. You don't need a prophet. You don't even need a brother or sister to teach you, because it doesn't say that your brother or sister teaches you. It says the Holy Spirit is your teacher. So that means, as scripture says here, but the anointing which you have received of him abideth in you. And you need not that any man teach you, but as the same anointing, which is Christ, Christ is the anointing, teach of you all things, which is the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit leads you to all truth and is truth. And is no lie. Even as it have taught you. Did you just hear that? The Holy Spirit teaches you. So that means, if you really think about it, brothers and sisters, you can see the deception in churches, right? You can see that we don't need anyone to teach us but the Holy Spirit. But then there's a lack of discernment in the body of Christ. They think everyone is teaching by the Holy Spirit. Everybody be teaching by the Holy Spirit. But no. Actually, there's many people that are teaching from their bellies. And so then your foundation was built on revelation of Jesus Christ, obviously, because he's revealed himself some way to the, or the other to you. But then all of a sudden, you started allowing man, not God, you started allowing man to build your house for you. Are we catching that? You started allowing man to build the house for you and stop relying on God to build the house for you. Because it's God that builds the house. Brothers and sisters, are we catching this? It's God that builds your house, not man. You let man build your house, you're going to have sand that builds that house. And then once trials and tribulations come against you, guess what's going to happen to your house? It's going to fall. Because it was built on traditions of man. It was built on doctrines of devils. It was built on theology. It was built on the letter instead of built on the spirit. Amen, Lexi. Lord, forgive us. Sister, I'm only speaking from my own experience, because that was my stumbling block. Because I was a babe in Christ a year and a bit ago, I stumbled because I stopped listening, didn't recognize it, because deception. I got deceived and man deceived me, and I started building my foundation on what my pastor says or what my brother says or what my sister says. And instead of taking it back to God and making sure that it's of God, not of man, making sure that it wasn't preached from someone's soul realm instead of the spiritual realm. So I didn't have that discernment. I was so fresh in my walk a year and a bit ago, and the Lord's like sharpened me like no other because of my own experience. Because to go through it, you got to go through it in order to receive wisdom, knowledge, understanding, the manifestation of the seven spirits of God. So you've got to go through it in order to speak it. Amen. And so because I've gone through it, God showed me a year and a bit ago, I started building my house on what man says to me. So then I was deceived by man because I allowed man to build my foundation. Because I was thinking everyone comes from Christ. I was thinking everyone is of Christ. No. Not everyone is of Christ. Not everyone is your brothers and sisters. And this is what you've got to recognize. It says, those who see and do the will of my Father are my brothers and sisters. Straight out of Jesus' mouth. But everyone thinks, like, because everyone goes to church, it's like, oh, that's my brother. Oh, that's my sister. There's actually a lot of people that haven't even come into the kingdom of God in the church.
Can I be real about that? There's a lot of people that have not
Sorry, I keep getting a phone call. We bind every distraction now in Jesus' name. There's a lot of people that are in church There's a lot of people that are in church, but not in Christ. Are we catching this? There's a lot of people that are in church, but not in Christ. So there's a lot of people that come and, you know, they do that Sunday, come to church every Sunday, but they're not working out their own salvation with fear and trembling. Mm-hmm. That's right, Nancy. I'm having so many people, and this is what breaks my heart, brothers and sisters. I'm having so many people like reach out to me like, oh, Mercedes, I need prayers. Oh, Mercedes, I need this. Oh, Mercedes, I need that. And I'm really recognizing it's because their foundation is rocky. And also they don't have security in Christ. They don't recognize that they have the same authority. So, yeah, we all have different measures of faith. But you can increase that faith too, because you only need faith as small as a mustard seed. Hello? We can't make excuses here. But you can increase that faith. Do you know what I mean? And I have so many people like messaging me and asking me for help and wanting me for prayers and all this jazz. And I'm just recognizing like, these poor souls haven't been taught correctly. These poor souls have been taught theology and not intimacy. These poor souls have been taught letter and not the spirit. So now I'm really recognizing these poor souls at the start, they received it by the hearing of faith, but now their foundation is starting to be built on a letter. Are we catching what I'm trying to say here? So now these poor souls, their foundation is so rocky because now the trials and tribulations are coming and they're like, Mercedes, help me. Do you know what I say when people message me for prayers and stuff? And I know because they see the anointing in my life. They see how I walk and all that jazz. But we can all walk this way. We just have to be disciplined in it, right? And so I literally look up to God and I'm like, God, I am one woman. Like, I literally say to God, like, Lord, I am one woman. Like, I have such a passion to teach sound doctrine because of all my brothers and sisters that literally cling to me and be like, I need you to help me, I need a prayer, I need this, I need that. And I'm just sitting there like, holy moly, like Lord. And you know what I'm also thinking, brothers and sisters? It's like, you really, the scripture that highlights the most to me right now, there is plenty of harvest, but not enough laborers. So where are the laborers? Do you know what I'm trying to say? We need to stop being slothful, wicked servants, and start being laborers of God. We got to stop looking at ourselves. You know, that's what the devil wants you to do. He wants you to look at your misery. He wants you to look at the stuff that's happening in your life. But you know what? You're looking at the wrong thing. You should be looking at Jesus. You should be looking at Jesus. Because I sit there and I'm like, Lord, I'm a one man woman. I'm one. I'm one. There's only one Mercedes. Now I know how Jesus felt. You know, come on, Holy Spirit, speak to me. Come on, Holy Ghost, let's go. This is why Jesus said, we're going to do greater things than what he did. Because guess what? We're greater in numbers. And you can't tell me that the same spirit that rose Jesus from the dead isn't the same spirit that's in you that rose you from the dead. You can't tell me that. Because if you do tell me that, that means you have labored in vain and you believed in vain. Guys, I'm about to get righteously angry right now because we need to stop being slothful servants. God ain't coming back for no slothful servants. God don't want to use slothful servants. He wants to use servants that are ready, that want to say yes, that say no to the things of the world and say, yes, Lord, I'll do it. Lord, send me, send me. You know, and that was my prayer. I was like, God, send me, send me. And now he's sending me. And I'm just like, where's the others? Like, where's the others? Yeah, now I do. Oh, goodness gracious. Oh, I do. I do. I do. I do, Ralph. I'm like, send me, God. Send me. So every person on here, you gotta start praying to God, send me. Because holy moly, guys, there is so much harvest out there, but I can't even find many laborers. And I'm gonna say that in love, and I'm gonna say that with boldness. I can barely find any laborers. I don't find people that are lifting up sound doctrine. I'm not finding them, I'm not seeing them. Do you know, I wanted to be with God just because of this, because I said, Lord, if we're supposed to like be your people, we're your children, and we're supposed to manifest your life here, I don't see it. I don't see the love of Jesus. I don't see the love of Jesus in the church. I don't see the love of Jesus everywhere I look. I don't see it. And I said, Lord, take me home. I don't want to be around wicked, slothful servants. I don't want to be around this, Lord. And this is why he said, and that's why I need you there. That's why I need you to stay there. That's why I need you to go minister to my children. I'm like, Lord. So guys, sometimes I'm just like, more grace. Honestly, at times I'm like, Lord, more grace. More grace, because this is, honestly, we really feel what Jesus is feeling. Like, I don't know about you guys, but I'm feeling what Jesus is feeling. Like, Jesus was one man. One man. And all these sick people were coming at him, and they were like, you know, running up to him and just like, oh, I need you. I'm sick. I need prayers and blah, blah, blah. That's how I feel, guys. I feel that. And I'm just like, I'm only one person, Lord. One person. One person. Guys, it's time for us to stop being like, we've got to stop being slothful servants and start doing God's work. Jesus worked. God worked. We need to work. This is me working. I come on here, I minister, I say a word to you guys. This is me working. I go and heal and deliver people by the Holy Ghost. I work. I minister to unbelievers. I work. It's not rocket science, guys. It's like instantly, like we should know this by now. We should be out there harvesting souls. We should be out there telling someone about Jesus. We shouldn't even care about, what I'm going to say. It don't matter what you're going to say. If you're led by the Spirit's going to minister to that person. See, everyone thinks that they're the ones that have to work. No, you just have to be a willing vessel. You just have to prepare a vessel for God to come and minister through. That's all you have to do. Do you know what I'm trying to say? That's all you have to do. God doesn't ask for much from us. He actually asks us anywhere there's been afflicted, anywhere we've been afflicted by the devil. He wants us first to heal. He wants us to get deliverance. He wants to heal us. He wants to remove the thorns in our hearts, in our flesh. He wants to remove it all. He would rather use clean vessels. But he will use vessels that are hungry, willing, that know they've fallen short at God's glory, but they are repentive. They're remorseful like David. They're like, Lord, search me, O God. If there's any wickedness in me, search me, O God, so that I can come to a revelation that, Lord, so I can repent from any wickedness in my heart. If I've lift up slander, gossip, if I'm envy, if I'm sowing discord, Lord, if I'm sowing disunity, God, show me. Where's the cry for God's people? You know, people are like, oh, revival come, revival come, revival come. But revival needs to start in us first before it can manifest out to the nations. Are we catching that? If revival hasn't happened to you, you can't carry revival to the nations. There's reasons why there's so much wickedness in our countries. It's because we haven't risen up. Sorry to bust your bubble, but we haven't been doing what we're called to do. We're called to govern. We're called to tear down every wicked thing that's operating in our territory. So people are praying for revival to come. How about start praying for God to heal you so revival can come? Because it first has to start with us. Because how can you... You are the revival. You individually are the revival. If God can revive you, guess what? You can revive thousands. It only takes one person to set a nation free. But if God doesn't have vessels to carry his revival, it's just dead. It's just dead. You know what I'm trying to say, guys? So as I said to you, you guys have the anointing in you. You have the anointing in you. If you have died with Christ, rise with Christ, you have the anointing in you to heal the sick, heal the unclean, you know, heal the sick, heal the blind, drive out the unclean spirits. You have the anointing in you. It's Jesus Christ who anoints you. It's Jesus Christ who anoints you. It's got nothing to do with you. It's what already abides in you. Do you not know that what's in you was formed in you from the beginning before the foundations were even built? It's all there. That's right. It's all there. He's given you all spiritual blessings, all spiritual gifts, but you've got to be able to tap into it. And the only way you're going to tap into it is you're going to persevere. It's endurance. Does not scripture say that we endure until we're saved? If people think giving their life to Jesus is them being saved, you got one thing. No, because did you endure to be saved? No, you just invited Jesus to be your Lord and Savior. Do you know we are literally, brothers and sisters, if I could really say this to you, we are literally supposed to feel Jesus' suffering. When you truly... When you truly feel the suffering of Jesus, that's when you can turn around and say, I bear the marks of Jesus Christ in my hands. I bear the marks of Jesus. I bear the nails. I bear the nails. I bear it, because you literally go through a spiritual suffering. I can't tell you how much, guys. I've died 1,000 deaths and 1,000 and 1,000 and 1,000 and 1,000. I've died 1,000 deaths, and that's where God has been able to manifest his mercy, his grace, because I recognize that, my goodness, we need to die more. We need to die more. Paul says, I die daily. Praise God, Lexi. Receive this correction. May everyone receive this correction. The harvest is plenty, brothers and sisters, but the laborers are a few. And it's time for the church to rise up. It's time for the laborers to stand up. Don't wait for man to anoint or appoint you. Because it ain't man that anoints and appoints. It's God himself that anoints and appoints. So in your season right now, you're probably going through some pressing, some crushing, some refining. Because he actually wants to use you. He wants to use all his children. Anyone that puts their hands up and say, yes, use me. He said, awesome. Now when you say use me... Oh, Lord, when you say use me, you don't know what you're praying for. But the suffering that you're going to go through, will perfect you. perfect you. You might be like, yeah, use me, Lord, but you don't even know what you're praying for. But some assurance and some encouragement, that's the heart that God chooses to use, is someone that says, use me. Use me. Whatever it takes, whatever it takes, whatever I got to do, whatever I got to die to, whatever it is, God, use me. It is. It's painful, but it is very beautiful. Can you get a word for me? Boris is my name. I'm not a clairvoyant. You don't just snap your fingers and ask for a word. But Boris, if you have a relationship with Jesus, seek him. Your word is to ask God, if there's any deception in me, reveal it. And if I can't hear you for myself, tell me. This is not against you, Boris, and it's okay, I forgive you. It's nice to get a word. I do too. Like, you know, when the Lord leads me to places to get a word, but I don't even have to ask for a word. Do you know what I mean? I come in and instantly someone will be like, hey, woman of God, blah, 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 blah. And obviously I test it. I test all words that are spoken over me. And most of it is usually confirmation. The word is only to bring confirmation. So the word, brothers and sisters, is only to confirm what you're already hearing from your Father. Are we catching that? Apostles, prophets, all them, they're only just to confirm that you're still walking in alignment with God's will for you. That's it. There's nothing fancy about it. They're only just confirming what God has already spoken to you. And your spirit, and if you are being short account with God and you're pressing in and you're, you know, keeping yourself clean, not touching the unclean things, you will be able to bear witness to people speaking the word of God over you. I'm just attacked in a big way. God told me to do a few things and I got scared and now it's my life upside down and my mom's sick and it's really hard for me right now. So I'm guessing you haven't done those few things. And as I hear in my spirit, you have rebelled against God because you haven't done what God has told you to do. Do you know rebellion? Do you know sickness manifests because of rebellion? Do you know that? Sickness. Spot reaction. Don't come here with your false doctrines. Don't come here with your devil doctrines. Don't come here with your influences. If you see that this is not a Muslim live or whatever, please move along. Unless you're here to learn, by all means stay. But if you're here to convert, walk. walk. People are looking for deliverance. People are looking for healing. People ain't looking for religion. So if you're called to write a book and sing, okay. If you haven't done that, repent. Repent. Acknowledge that you've rebelled against God and you haven't done what He's called you to do. Repent. It's God's goodness that leads us to repentance. Okay? And I hear the Lord saying fear. Boris, that you've allowed fear into your heart. And because you've allowed fear into your heart, you have opened up gateways that are manifesting in you and in your family. Acknowledge that you have come into agreement with fear, because God has not given you the spirit of fear, Boris, but of love and sound mind. Sometimes we just miss the mark. We just miss the mark. We think we hear God, or we get deceived and we rebel against God and we don't do what God tells us to do. And all He's trying to do is just teach us to recognize that we need Him. That's all He's trying to teach us. We need Him. We need to walk in Him, because walking in Him is walking in the light. If we aren't doing what He calls us to do, guess what we're doing? We're walking in darkness. And that's walking in deception. I have a really bad past, and it's really hard to get over the past. I like mean the worst of it. We've all had a bad past. All of us have. But are we gonna continuously allow the devil to make us a victim? Or are we gonna allow Jesus to make us a victor? Don't be nervous, Melina. And I'm saying that in love, Boris. I'm not pushing aside what's happened to you. I just know that I serve a mightier God. I just know that my God is bigger than trauma. My God is bigger than triggers. My God is bigger than anything. And nothing, and I mean nothing, compares, Boris, to the glory that is to be revealed in you. Nancy, no one is perfect. Yeah, see, these are the kind of languages that really make me righteously angry. When we say no one is perfect, how can we say that we are of Christ and speak the opposite to what we're called to be? We're called to be perfect as He is perfect, holy as He is holy. What we need to recognize is man is not perfect. But that doesn't mean that you're not going to be perfect, because it's not man that perfects you. It's the Spirit that perfects you. It's Christ that perfects you. Amen? That's right. If He can heal you, He can heal anyone. If He can heal me from the trauma and the triggers and the affliction that the devil has afflicted me from a child to now, He can heal anyone. And it's not even about comparing, guys. We've all gone through something. But are we going to allow that something to keep us in bondage? Or are we going to allow that something to be to overcome by the blood of the Lamb, which is Jesus Christ, and the word of our testimony? That's right, Jason. We are made perfect through Him. So we've got to also recognize when we say we're not perfect. And you're in Christ and you're saying we're not perfect. I know it's a process, guys, but it's also about renewing our mind too. God can't pour new wine into old wineskin. God cannot pour His revelations, the Holy Spirit, into flesh. A natural man can't understand the things of the heavenly. That's right, Jack. Let the Holy Spirit guide us. Do you know, I don't even say that I'm not perfect anymore. That's not even in my vocabulary anymore. Because anywhere that's saying I'm not perfect, I limit God working through me. Mm-hmm. We can speak that so blindly and ignorantly over ourselves, but you don't recognize that you literally just stop a blessing over your life because of your words have bondaged you. Mm-hmm. That ain't even in my vocabulary. That's in the world's vocabulary, but it ain't in mine. Yes, we fall short of God's glory because God, it's a process and we are God's workmanship and He's working us all into perfection. Hallelujah. But that doesn't mean that you're not going to... It doesn't mean that you're not, you know what I mean? It doesn't mean you're going to be fallen for the rest of your life. It means that in those areas where you have fallen short, it's just showing you, you need more discipline in that area. You need more of the Holy Spirit in that area. You need to decrease more in that area. You need more death in that area. You need to die in that area. Like, I'm preaching to the choir, guys. Honestly, I'm preaching to the choir. I'm only speaking from my own experience. When I've fallen short, it's because I'm like, shoot, Lord, I need more of you. I need more of you in this area. I need more of you in this area. I need more of you in this area, Lord. God, I can't do it without you. Lord, forgive me where I didn't even add you into this area. Do you know what I'm trying to say? We've got to, and I say this in love, and I say this in such an encouragement. Sometimes, brothers and sisters, you gotta fall. So the pressing can even be greater. Because when you fall, guess what? You gain wisdom, you gain knowledge, you gain understanding. You ain't gonna fall down that road ever again, are you? Because when you fall, you recognize the areas that you have fallen short in and you need more of Him. Mercedes, are you ever coming to America? I am. I'm coming to America. Please keep me in prayer. I'm just waiting for God to say go. And I'm like, immediately, I'm going. But I'm coming to America. Man, I can't wait to... The crusade is going to be great. To be able to minister to people like I'm ministering to you guys like this on the phone. Man, demons are just going to flee. Do you know what I'm trying to say? Like, demons are going to flee. Devil's going to manifest. Like, demons are just going to... Honestly, they will, because it's time. Yeah, I'm coming. I am. Melina, I'm coming. Please keep me in prayer. Just keep me in prayer. Just, you know, however the Lord leads you, but please pray for me. Pray that God continuously opens, like keeps me consecrated in Him, keeps me hearing His voice and not other people's voice. Just keep me in prayer. Praise the Lord, Melina. Yeah, I'm coming, girl. I'm coming. The Lord gave it to me last year and said, I'm sending you to America. And I was like, okay, Lord, let's go. Let's go. I'm excited. But anyways, guys, when you fall short of God's glory, it's not a bad thing. It's just recognizing that's an area that God needs to refine you in. That's an area that God needs to press you in. That's an area that God needs to crush you in. Are you catching that? That's it. But when you fall short in God's glory, if you fall short of God's glory, right, don't condemn yourself. Do not condemn yourself. Do not even put shame upon yourself. Like, hear what the Spirit of the Lord is saying. God, when you fall short of the glory of God, God doesn't condemn you. God definitely doesn't shame you. Do you know what I'm trying to say? So anywhere that you've sinned, fell short, whatever, you've got to be able to recognize what voice are you listening to. What voice are you listening to? If it's a voice of condemnation, if it's a voice of guilt, if it's a voice of shame, well, that ain't coming from the tree of life. That's coming from the knowledge of good and evil. That's coming from the devil. That ain't coming from the Father. That's coming from the liar, the father of all lies. That ain't coming from your father. If your father is my father or my father is your father, that's not the voice of my Father. Thank you, Father. This is how we need to be sharp, brothers and sisters, of hearing God's voice. God's voice will always, always, and I mean always, speak life. God's voice will be a rebuke, an edifying, and an exhortation. He will rebuke you in love, because he'll just be like, you just know, guys, you know. I don't know about you guys, but like, I'm so sensitive to God's convictions. Like, I'll be just like, get annoyed at someone or whatever, or I'll say something, you know, out of my flesh or whatever, and I'll instantly get convicted. I'll instantly like, I'm sorry, God. I'm sorry, Father. And I recognize that's an area that God needs to kill me more. That's an area that God needs to literally, that I need to decrease in and He needs to increase. Amen? That's it. That's right. The Father will always show love. Always. Always show love. The Father will always show love. The Father will always show love, brothers and sisters. Always. Absolutely always. Because what? Perfect love. Hear this. As I hear the Father really so strongly to say this. Perfect love casts out all fear. Sinks. Oh my goodness. Praise the Lord you're here. Because I came on here for you. Perfect love casts out all fear. So, if the voice that you're hearing isn't of love, isn't making you run to the presence of God, making you run away from the presence of God, that ain't the voice of God. Brothers and sisters, I'm here to set it straight. That's the voice of the devil. That's the voice of the stranger. And you're supposed to be his sheep that hear his voice. You're not supposed to listen to the voice of a stranger. The sheep don't follow the voice of a stranger. The sheep follow the shepherd. Amen? And as I hear the Father saying, brothers and sisters, who bewitched you? Who bewitched you? Where you were made, where Jesus was made perfect by the Spirit, and now you think you're being made perfect by the flesh? Who bewitched you? You were literally delivered by the Spirit. Why have you gone back into the flesh? When Jesus said, Father, forgive them for they don't know what they do, when he was hanging on that cross for all of us, he was saying, Father, forgive them for they don't know what they do. Father, forgive them for they don't know what they do. Do you know what Jesus was literally saying to the Father? Like, he was pleading for mercy for mankind. And he said, Father, forgive them for they don't know what they do. And he was literally saying they're spiritually blinded. They can't see what they're doing. They can't even see that they're crucifying the Messiah. But catch this. Catch this in the realms of the Spirit, by the Spirit of the Lord. When Jesus said now, when he gave his spirit into the Father, he said, I give my ghost back to you, like I give myself to you. The veil came down. Hear what the Lord is saying here. The veil came down, brothers and sisters. And that's when the Romans were around Jesus and they said, we have killed the Messiah. Because guess what? The flesh was torn from the top to bottom. And they could see instantly that they had killed the Messiah. This should convict all of us. The Romans, the people that crucified Jesus on that cross, said, we have killed the Son of Man. We have killed the Messiah. Do you know every time that you condemn yourself, you condemn Jesus back on the cross? Do you know every time you speak death over yourself, you kill Jesus all over again? Your words crucify him back to the cross. Mm-hmm. See, what you all need to recognize is, Sinks, I feel like God hates me because I had this thought where Jesus hid in me. No, God doesn't hate you. I rebuke every lie. I rebuke every lie that you've come in agreement with. I detach you from every deception that has come to deceive you from your call, Sinks. The devil comes to steal, kill, and destroy, but Jesus comes to give life and life in abundance. And I just decree and declare life over you right now. I decree and declare life over you right now. I speak life over your mind. I speak life into your womb. I speak life into your wells right now. In the name of Jesus, I command that heaviness to be lifted off you right now. In the name of Jesus, I rebuke every depression right now. I rebuke the spirit of murder. I rebuke the spirit of suicide over you right now. In the name of Jesus, that your word, the word that dwells within you will come forth and prosper in the name of Jesus. Lord, I pray that you tear down every false doctrine, devil doctrine, mixed doctrine under my voice, Father. I tear down every false doctrine, devil doctrine, mixed doctrine that has deceived her right now in the name of Jesus. I come against the spirit of death right now to loose her in the realms of the spirit. Loose her now in the name of Jesus. You will not spiritually kill the word that dwells within her. I decree and declare life right now. I break every chain. I break every shackle right now in the name of Jesus. Lord, I thank you, God, that your word says the devil comes to steal, kill, and destroy. But Jesus, you come to give life and life in abundance. And I speak life over her right now. I speak life over her right now in the name of Jesus. And I command the Prince of Peace to manifest in her life right now in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. I speak the Prince of Peace over her mind right now. I bind every tormenting spirit that's attacking her right now. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Lord, I pray you breathe afresh upon Sinks right now. Breathe afresh upon her right now. Lord, I call down fire in the realms of the spirit to burn the dross, the chaff, the wind in Jesus' mighty name. May she hear you right now. May she hear you right now. May she hear you, Lord. I pray for clarity. I thank you, God, that she has the helmet of salvation on, the breastplates of righteousness, the belt of truth, the preparation of the gospel of peace, the shield of faith, and the sword of the Spirit. Lord, I pray you teach her hands to war and her fingers to fight in Jesus' name. May you quicken her mortal body right now in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. 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 It's not by might, it's not by power, it is by his Spirit, saith the Lord. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen, amen, amen. See, brothers and sisters, this is why we need to be praying for one another. We need to be interceding for one another. We need to be interceding for the body of Christ. And yes, Lord, I need to intercede for the body of Christ more. But the devil is a liar. The devil is a liar. He is a cunning, cunning snake. He is a liar. And we fall under deception when we listen to lies. Amen? You're so welcome, Sinks. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. All glory to my Father in heaven. This is how, thank you, Father. This is how you know when you've come under deception. This is how you know when you've been eating at the wrong tree. This is how you know that you've been listening to the wrong voices. You start getting tired. You get slumber. You you your um You're not reading your word as much. You're not spending time in his presence. You're not spending time in worship. That's how the devil starts taking you out. Inch by inch by inch, he wears you out. He'll wear you out with just a little lie, just a tiny lie. And then it goes into your heart and you listen to that lie. And then guess what? That lie starts opening up you to fear. And then that fear opens you up into all sorts of tormenting spirits that attack your mind. This is why, brothers and sisters, we got to be so vigilant, watchful, prayerful. We got to be sober, watchful, prayerful, vigilant. We got to be watching our eye gates. We got to be making sure, what are we watching? We got to be so protective of our ear gates. What are we allowing into our ear gates? And what do we, and what we've allowed into our ear gates, does it contradict the word of God? Or is it of the word of God? Then you've got to guard your heart where the devil has afflicted your soul. If there's any unhealed issues in your heart where you felt rejected as a little girl, felt rejected as a little boy, where you felt rejection, abandonment, I don't know, whatever it is, whatever insecurities that the devil's brought in, whatever it is. If you haven't been healed by that, that's what the devil can continuously use against you. Praise God, Melina. How do you know I haven't? What do you mean, how do you know I haven't? I'm speaking in general, sister. I speak from my own experience. So when I speak, I'm speaking from my own experience, guys. I recognize when I become spiritually dead, and I've had it happen many times the year and a bit ago, and my prayer life went downhill. My, you know, the word went downhill. I didn't read the word as much, you know. I wasn't praying as much, you know. It just flood open wide the gates. It just flood wide open the gates, honestly. I mean, Job is a perfect example. The reason why Job, the enemy started attacking Job was because fear crept into his heart. Mm-hmm. And then he also carried the word with no knowledge of the word that dwells within him. Because guess what? He was saying, like, it was better for me to die. It was better for me not to be even alive. But he didn't recognize he was literally speaking death over God's creation, which is himself. Do you know how much it grieves God's heart when we speak death over ourselves? Because not only are you speaking death over... Yes, Lord. Thank you, Father. Not only are you speaking death over yourself, you're speaking death over his son, which we have supposedly have died to and rise with. So can you recognize how our body isn't our body anymore? Can you recognize that? When you speak death over yourself, you're speaking death over God's children. Mm-hmm. Yep. Yep, you sure do. When you condemn yourself, you condemn God's creation. When you speak death over yourself, you speak death over God's creation. So what we got to recognize, are we people of life or are we people of death? We're people of life, right? But if we don't have that revelation that we're people of life, we just read it in the Bible, don't have a revelation of it, then it's a dead letter and you can't manifest it. Yeah, come on, Melina. Do you know, and I've said this before and I keep saying it, do you know when I heard pastors and brothers and sisters call themselves sinners and I started mimicking them, I started eating what they were eating, speaking what they were speaking, and I started picking up death, literally. Hear what the Spirit of the Lord is saying here. I literally started speaking death over myself and over my own brothers and sisters. I started calling myself a sinner. I started calling myself wretched and filthy and, you know, he can't even look upon me, all that jazz, because I had that spoken over me. And then because that was spoken over me, I ate that. And then I ate that. And then I spoke it over other people. Do you know how poisonous that is, guys, when we're not watching our eye gates, ear gates, mouth gates? There's no fear of the Lord when you just let all this stuff just come out of your mouth. God slapped me in the face spiritually, like the conviction that I had to the core when I called myself a sinner. He turned around and said to me, Mercedes, if you call yourself a sinner, then you call my son a sinner. And it's like the Lord had to show me the difference of man to Christ. And when he really divided the word so truthfully for me, I was like, wow. I repented, guys. That's why you won't hear me speak anything that's not of God. Mm-mm. And the reason why I came in agreement with being wretched and a filthy and a sinner, because I had an orphan spirit. I had an orphan mindset. And I had brothers and sisters that continuously spoke the law over me. They continuously spoke death over me. And they weren't aware of it. Of course not, because they wouldn't be speaking something, you know, if they knew it, right? This is how quick you're going to come into conviction, is you literally, when you start, like, God's going to convict you so quickly, so quickly. If you are staying short account with God and you're washing your ear gates, eye gates, mouth gates, all your gates, making sure all your gates are sanctified, set apart, consecrated unto the Lord, you cannot go wrong with God. You will be right before man and right before God, right before God and right. If you're right with God, you're right with man. But I started allowing death to be spoken over me, and I started speaking condemnation over me. Yeah, that's right, Jason. So I grab people real quickly when they speak death over themselves, and I grab people real quickly when they speak death over me. Someone says, oh, you know, we're all not perfect and all that jazz, and I'd be like, don't involve me in that. See, thank you, Father. Brothers and sisters. Wow, come on, Holy Spirit. That's powerful. When people speak, it's the issues. It comes from the issues of life, right? And as the Lord was just speaking to me, when people speak, they speak from the issues of their life. And if there's unhealed issues in their life, they're going to speak from that. So say, for example, for me, I had rejection issues. I had abandonment issues. I had all that until God healed me. But I spoke it out because that's what was in my heart. That was unhealed issues that I was unaware of. It wasn't until God had to reveal it for myself, reveal it to me. And so we've got to recognize that we speak from life. We don't speak from the knowledge of good and evil. We don't speak from the knowledge of good and evil. Knowledge of good and evil will teach you to, will make you speak that you're wretched, you're filthy, you're a sinner. Knowledge of good and evil will continuously speak death over you, good or bad. But we are people that are of life. And so anything that comes out of our mouth, brothers and sisters, need to come out with life. See, what we need to recognize is the body, the woman represents the body, the soul represents the man. Let's get that straight, because God teaches me spiritually. The body is supposed to feed the soul. So, for example, what are you feeding your soul? Are you making your soul sick? Or are you speaking life into your soul? See, we're the body of Jesus. And you want to allow filth to go into Jesus? We're the temples of the Holy Spirit. So that means we are earthen vessels that carry Jesus. And we want to go and feed our souls with death? Does that make sense? See, we all speak about, like, the spirit. We don't teach enough about the soul. But you need to know, brothers and sisters, you are the soul and the body. Because Jesus was the fullness of the Godhead bodily, so he was the soul, the body, and the spirit. Those who are one with the Lord are one with the Spirit. So really, we should be oneness with the soul, body, spirit. So if you know you're one with the soul, the body, and spirit, what are you feeding your body? What are you feeding your soul? And what are you feeding your spirit? And when you truly recognize that, you're going to recognize to be mindful of now what you feed your soul, what you feed your body, and what you feed the spirit. See, I'll use this for an example. I was listening to this a friend, worldly friend, was listening to this filthy ass song that I used to like listen to in the clubs. And when I was listening to it, because I was in the car with them, I couldn't just jump out the door. Guess what happened to me? Because I listen to my soul. Do you listen to your souls? I listen to my souls. I listen to my soul. And I sat there, and when that music went straight into my ear gates and straight into my soul, it made me sick. Brothers and sisters, it made me sick to my stomach. And that's how in tuned I am with my soul. That's how in tuned I am with my body. That's how in tuned I am with my spirit. That my soul hated that song, hated that filthy, seducing, seductive song coming into my ear gates and into my soul. And I literally felt my soul being sick. Blessing, sister. I literally felt my soul being sick, like I wanted to vomit physically because my soul was so sick of what was coming into my ear gates. And I was like, Lord, and you know what I did? I went like this. I put my headphones on. I put my headphones on and I bled the worship into my soul. I bled the worship into my soul. I was like, ugh, it was disgusting. Now tell me, brothers and sisters, are you in tuned with what your soul is saying to you? Are you in tuned with your body? Are you in tuned with your soul? Are you in tuned with your spirit? Because I am. When I hear someone speaking filthy around me, my soul does this. Oh my goodness. Oh, I get this. It's like a massive rebuke in me. Internally, I feel this rebuke, like, no. And I'm not surprised. I mean, my soul's been beaten. My soul's been afflicted. My soul has had triggers. My soul don't want to be listening to any more death. No, thank you. But I hear my soul. I hear it. Like, guys, I literally... You've got to be in tune with your body. If you're not in tune with your body like that, then ask God to help you to be in tune with your body, because you're going to start having sharper discernment that you don't allow that into your ear gates. Mm-mm, don't allow that into your gates. You don't allow that into your heart, your soul, your body, mm-mm, your spirit. And I also get this stabbing pain in my chest. Because I hate it. I hate when someone defiles the word of my Father. I hate it. Oh, it gets into me and I'm like, I hate it. I'm that sensitive that, like, if I hear something trying to defile, especially defiling the living word, let alone this word, someone interprets this word according to their bellies. Oh my goodness. I'm like, oh Lord, I get like that. And we get like, do you know what I mean, guys? And I pray that you're becoming that sensitive, because we need to be that sensitive. We're in some crazy times. And if you can't be able to be in tune with your soul, of how your soul's feeling, of how your body's feeling, of how the spirit's feeling, then I don't know what to say. Mm-mm, that's not good. Mm-hmm. Absolutely, Melina. It grieves my soul. My soul, my body, my spirit, it grieves it all. My soul, my body, and spirit are one. Because those who are one with the Lord, and who's the Lord? Jesus Christ. He's the fullness of God's Godhead bodily. So he's the head, he's the body, and he's the soul. He's the fullness, right? So if he's the fullness of God, of the Godhead bodily, that means we, the Holy Spirit manifesting on us, is the fullness of Jesus Christ. But God is bringing all things to perfection through our much suffering, and I mean much suffering. He's bringing our soul into unity with Jesus's soul. He's bringing our body into unity with Jesus's body. He's bringing our spirit in unity with Jesus's spirit. Because those who are one with the Lord are one with the Spirit. Amen? Hey, sister. God bless you. Anyone want to come up? Come, please. Wins, come up. All of my beautiful souls, come up. Sorry, Lord. I love hearing God speak through me. I mean, I love hearing my brothers and sisters too. Do you know what I mean? Because I was going to say, I don't like hearing the sound of my voice, but it's not my sound that I'm hearing. It's the voice of God because, yeah. Thank you, Lord, for even helping me to renew quickly in that. So, you need to be in tune. You need to be in tune with your body. You need to be in tune with the food. You need to be in tune with your food spiritually and physically. Now tell me, anyone on here, who's in tune with their body like that? Do you know what makes your soul sick? And as I hear the Father saying this right now, sorry, excuse me. Do you know who made... Do you know what happened in the Garden of Eden? The word, the spoken word, who is supposed to represent the knowledge of good and evil. Remember when God said, you can freely eat from the knowledge of good, you can freely eat from the tree of life, except for that tree, the knowledge of good and evil. Because if you eat from that tree, you'll surely die. So anyways, that was spoken to Adam, not the woman. Then the woman was deceived by just the word that was spoken from Satan into her ear gates, went straight into her soul, into her body, and guess what? Started perverting the word in her. And because it perverted the word in her, guess what happened? When the woman spoke over the man, because we are supposed to feed each other's soul with life, did you notice that the woman literally killed the man in the Garden of Eden? Did you notice that? Brothers and sisters, we're not here to kill each other. We're here to love one another. We're here to speak life into each other. Are we catching this? So when the man ate from the woman, it spiritually killed him. And it spiritually killed them both. And they went from a heavenly mindset, a heavenly dimension. Really catch this. They dropped down to a physical dimension. Are you catching that? So when they dropped down to a physical dimension, guess what? They recognized they were naked. Because now they were in a carnal realm. They weren't in a heavenly realm where they were innocent, pure, sanctified unto the Lord and all that. They came down here. So do you know when we repent? Do you know when we fall short of God's glory? We fall short from the heavenly realm back to the carnal realm. Mm-hmm. And then when we recognize God, we remember God, we recognize that we were of God and we are, God dwells within us, Emmanuel, God with us. We repent, and guess what? We go back up here. And then we fall again. We go back up here. Are we catching that? So what you need to recognize, if you're not watching your ear gates or eye gates or mouth gates, you allow something into ear gates, eye gates, mouth gates, you're from here and you're like doing so well with the Lord, then all of a sudden you're here. Because you started eating from the knowledge of good and evil with your eyes, with your ears, and with your mouth. Are we catching that? Mm-hmm. Yeah, Lexi. That's why you hear me, guys, continuously. I'm a repetitive record with you guys. Like, I continuously speak to you that I am very mindful who I eat with. I am very mindful who I literally sit with. I am mindful who I allow to minister to me and vice versa. Mm-mm. But we don't get taught this, do we? We don't get taught this in the church to be mindful of our eye gates, ear gates, mouth gates, because everyone is fornicating in the church. Mm-hmm. Yep. Everyone is fornicating spiritually in the church. Mm-hmm. Everyone is operating in adultery in the church. What is adultery? When you leave your lover, Jesus Christ, and you run after other lovers. That's spiritual adultery. Fornication is when you leave Jesus' flesh and you glorify your flesh. That's fornication. See, can you see how when the Pharisees back in the Old Testament, can you see how they defiled God's word by their own lack of understanding? Can you see how a lot of people read the Bible carnally and not spiritually? So they were here when they read the Bible. They weren't here. So they weren't one with God. They were here. They were one with self. And self is one with Satan. So guess how Satan continuously does? He defiles the word when we're here in the carnal state until we come back to this understanding that we are spiritual beings and we live in this spiritual atmosphere, spiritual realm, dimensions. But no, we don't get taught this, do we? We're not getting taught this in churches, no. Because if this gets taught in the churches, then it removes the scales, doesn't it? If this gets taught in the churches, that means they have to actually live a holy, sanctified, set apart, consecrated life, right? That's how cunning the devil is. Because everyone in the church are all under, like, most people in churches are in deception. Most people in churches are in, are being grieved. The Holy Spirit in them has been grieved. They are literally being captured and in bondage. Mm-hmm. I kind of invite people up. Nope, I can see how it's an arrogant. So you can see why most of us is ministering on here, right? Because most of the things that are spoken here, you wouldn't hear on the pulpit, would you? Now, can you see why God has us coming together and eating together? Because this is what church is, brothers and sisters. Church, this is what a church is. This is how we are to be a church. We are to be bold, rebuke in love, edify and exhort. Because if there's no rebuke, there's no edifying, there's no exhorting, then they remain a babe and they never step into knowledge of God or the revelation of Jesus Christ. So they remain spiritually, they're spiritually aborted until they come to the revelation that they've been under bondage. And that's when they break free because of the anointing in them. So weird. I can't seem to add you up. It's so weird. Oh, whatever, Lord. So we've got to recognize, guys. We've got to recognize that we serve a holy God. Lord, whatever is happening to this airway, we command it to loose in Jesus' mighty name. In Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, Lord. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. During all that stuff. But can I drive on TikTok?
As long as you don't show the hello. Vote.
Okay. My Wi-Fi. I don't know. Work in Jesus' name. How are you? Yeah. Are we glitching?
Yeah.
Oh, that's so weird. Why are we glitching? Go away in Jesus' name. We bind every spiritual wickedness, everything in high places in the name of Jesus. In the name of... Okay. Is that better?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Hi, guys!
How you doing, Mercedes?
I'm good, thank you. How are you all?
I'm doing beautiful. Sounds like he's bringing you into the Godhead.
Oh, yeah, I'm loving it. I'm loving it. It's amazing.
I told you.
Yeah, ministering from the Godhead is powerful.
Yes, yes.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, it's beautiful, Lord. Yeah, because, well, I mean, you can only minister from the Godhead. Do you know what I mean? That's where the fullness is from the Godhead.
Exactly.
And so he's really just unraveled so much for me. Bless you, Prophetess Shay. Yeah. Oh my goodness. It's incredible. Oh, thank you, Sissy. I love you. Come up. Yeah, God's doing massive things. Massive things, Lord.
You know,
so how are you all? Mm-hmm.
One of the things that we need to be teaching is there's a difference between teaching to salvation and teaching from salvation. There's a lot of people out there that are teaching to salvation and not from salvation. They're trying to teach you how to get saved. And now that you're already saved, they're working from the wrong side of the cross.
Yeah, it's recognizing that salvation is free.
It's free. It's a free gift.
It's free gift. And we work from salvation. We literally, you know what I mean? It's not working to salvation. It's you're working from salvation, in salvation. Because if you truly have recognized, yeah, that's right. If you truly have recognized you've given your life to Jesus, you literally gave your life to Jesus. Hallelujah. And he is the gift. He is the perfect gift. He's the free gift. Thank you, Lord.
Amen. Praise God. In Christ Jesus. Staying in him.
Amen.
That's the whole key is to stay in him. It has nothing to do with how you start this race. The middle means nothing. It's finishing the race.
Stay in him.
Stay in the vine. In him.
Enduring.
Don't try to wander off in that vine.
It's not the journey, it's the destination.
Yeah. Yeah, amen.
Hey,
but
Shay,
really recognizing
you?
A lot of people.
Hey, Jason.
Yeah. just recognizing a lot of people don't understand what it means to be in Christ. They think they are in Christ doing what they're doing, but Christ wouldn't be sinning. I'll step on some toes. Christ wouldn't be sinning. Jesus didn't sin, right? And so if we are, you know, falling short in areas, that means we're not being in Christ. We're being in the flesh, right? And that's recognizing we need to decrease so he can increase.
We haven't
and
surrendered.
And that's only it.
We haven't surrendered our will to him.
Yes, that's right. There's a lot of areas too.
He that knows to do right and does it not, it is sin unto him. If any man shall follow me, he shall take up his cross. Be ye holy, for I am holy. The thing is there's a difference between what people are being taught and the truth. And that's when God changed me in my life. See, I was in a place where I was in some forms of idolatry. My life had become nothing but, you know, Candy Crush, Facebook, a cigarette, and a pain pill. And I told God one day, I said, I think that there's a lot more to salvation than me just saying Jesus is Lord and going to church and paying tithe. And he showed me.
It's you making
ask,
him.
If you ask for the full truth, he'll give it to you, you guys.
It's making him Lord of your life. Not just saying that he's Lord. It's making him Lord of your life.
Yes.
Allowing him to work through you for the big benefit of his kingdom.
Amen.
Amen. Amen, Lord. Amen. Yes, I love that. It's making him Lord of your life, not saying he is Lord of your life. That's so true, because that's when you really recognize that you haven't fully surrendered, like you said, Jason. Because he needs all areas of our life to be surrendered unto him.
And when you
and
do
don't
that,
we know all about that?
When you do that, he will bless you so much. I mean, when you can literally sit there and say, Lord, you are the Lord of my life, and you allow him to work through you and whatever aspect that he needs you in, man, he blesses you so much. It's amazing what he can do. It truly, truly is.
Thank you, Lord. Hi, amen.
Sister. I love my sister. Hi, everybody.
Hi, Wins. How are you, sister? Come on.
Yay, my sister. I know I've been a little bit skinned.
Hello.
I haven't been so
got
much
any
on
ministering. TikTok. Oh, that's
yes,
okay.
Yes.
Thank you, sister.
So, my sister.
Oh, bless all of you. Bless the gifts. Bless. Yes.
Yes. Sorry, man. I think my network is a little bit dipping. I hope you guys can hear me.
Or you just want
hello.
Yes. Oh, can hear you.
Okay. Awesome. So I haven't been on TikTok much lately.
Thank you, sister.
And so I've just been called because, you know, in the quiet place, spending time with God. And one of the things that he revealed to me during this time was that the mysteries lie in the spiritual realm. And you can only get to that place when you die to the flesh. And
come on.
Ooh, yay. Ooh. And I spent
after the Holy
quite
Ghost.
A
come
lot
on.
Of time just
in the spirit.
In the spirit. He speaks loud in the spirit. And there's a lot of things. I've actually got a scripture that I wanted to share. It's 2 Corinthians 5.
Yes, please do.
Verse 2.
Mm-hmm.
Verse 2. Where did I put my Bible? Okay.
Hey, Wins.
So it says, hi.
Wins, can you go ahead and read down to 19 as well?
So I won't follow any promises too.
Okay. So in Corinthians 5, verse 2, it says, for in this we groan, earnestly desiring to be clothed up with our house, which is from heaven.
Thank you, Father. Ooh,
yay. Hallelujah. And that speaks about the mantle upon our lives.
Oh, that's feeding my soul so much right now.
Yes, the garments that we are carrying, we need to be filled up with that garments of heaven. And we cannot be filled up with the flesh. And the thing about the church is that we focus so much on the worldly things.
Flesh.
And it keeps keeps on calling us to say that we need to be garment up. We need to go to God with our garments on. And it's not the garments that we put on, you know, the clothes that we wear, but it's the garment that he has given us, which is the white.
Come on.
The white garment, there's different garments. Apparently there is a different garments, and you discover that the more and more you read and you unlock these mysteries in the scriptures.
Come on. Hallelujah. Wow.
Yeah, my sister.
Lord. That's powerful.
Amen. That's powerful. Amen. Jason, you said I should read which verse?
I wanted you to read from 2 down to 19, if you could.
Which is in Corinthians 2?
Yep.
Till 19, from where I ended. Okay. If so, that being clothed, we shall not be found naked. For we that are in this tabernacle do groan, being burdened, not for that we would be unclothed, but clothed upon the mortality might be swallowed up of life. Now he that hath wrought us for the selfsame thing is God, who also hath given us the earnest of the Spirit. Therefore we are always confident, knowing that whilst we are at home in the body, we are absent from the Lord. For we walk by faith, not by sight. We are confident, I say, and willing rather to be absent from the body and to be present with the Lord. Wherefore we labor, that whether present or absent, we may be accepted of him. For we must all appear before the judgment seat of Christ, that everyone may receive the things done in his body according to that he hath done, whether it is to be good or bad. Okay? Knowing therefore the terror of the Lord, we persuade men, but we are made manifest unto God, and I trust also are made manifest in your consciousness. For we command not ourselves again unto you, but to give you occasion to glory on our behalf, that ye may have somewhat to answer, which glory in appearance and not in heart. For whether we be beside ourselves, it is to God, or whether we be sober, it is for your cause. For the love of Christ constraineth us, because we thus judge, that if one died for all, then we are all dead, and that he died for all, and that they which love should not henceforth love unto themselves, but unto which died for them and rose again.
Amen.
So, if one died for all, okay,
then he's died for all.
He's died for all, but he also lives for us all.
That's right. But there's also a dividing the word of God in that way of, if all have died, right, Jesus crucified all of us to the cross, whether people recognize that or not. He allowed his flesh to be crucified, which is our flesh. He came in the likeness of sinful nature, didn't do sin to fulfill God's law. But when he died, he rose from the dead 3 days later, right?
That's correct.
But not everyone has risen. People are still dead in Christ.
There are some that are still dead in Christ.
And there are some that are alive. That's what 1 Corinthians 15 speaks about. There will be many that won't fall asleep. There'll be many that will be turned, in the twinkling of an eye, be changed in the twinkling of an eye, which is being glorified. So, yes, all have died in Christ, and all is supposed to be risen in Christ, but it's a process, and we just got to be making sure that we're speaking the truth over everyone so they can be risen in Christ. Because if you're watering down the gospel, and this is what the Lord's really been highlighting heaps to me, if people are watering down the gospel, and we know this, right, because we all say it in churches, that the gospel has been watered down and all that jazz, but you acknowledge that. So if the gospel's been watered down, that means the truth hasn't been truly spoken.
It's been perverted. It's not been watered down. It's been perverted. Well,
Yeah, it's been defiled at the end of the day. So if the word of God has been defiled, come on, Shay. Yeah, but what the Lord revealed to me is if it's been watered down, defiled, whatever, then there's a scripture that speaks about how can the people be risen if they don't hear the shepherd's voice. And so if the word has been defiled or the word has been perverted or watered down, or then that means people aren't hearing its voice because they're hearing mixture. They're hearing theology. They're hearing traditions of man. They're hearing false doctrines, devil doctrines. That's what they're hearing. So you want the people haven't risen because they're not hearing the truth.
They're hearing condemnation.
It says, when you receive the truth, it shall set you free, right?
Right.
Mm-hmm. So that means if the truth isn't spoken, then people aren't going to raise from the dead, are they? But praise the Lord that he's raised up prophets or whatever. He's raised up shepherds that are after his own heart, that are speaking after his, that are speaking for him.
Speaking
and so they're speaking and God's raising up the dead through them.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
That's right. And praise the Lord for that.
Amen.
And I know this because I've come across a lot of spiritually dead brothers and sisters.
You and I both.
It seems to me that there's like seasons mm-hmm. where the Pharisee spirits come out even heavier. And right now, I've seen it increase the last week or two.
They're heavy.
And look, there's different times you mm-hmm. can hit me during my service. And depending on what I'm doing at the moment is what type of reaction you will get. Now, if you start that nonsense while I'm at worship, you're going to get the passiveness. But if I'm dealing with a soul wound, which mm-hmm. is the highest level of deliverance that someone can go mm-hmm. through, or the wounds of a soul, a fragment of mm-hmm. soul, these people mm-hmm. knowing not how many messages I give, Shay, I was going to unalive myself. Mm-hmm. But I felt the Holy Spirit and I didn't do it. I take that very seriously because what's the price tag you can put on a soul, okay? Mm. You know, this is what an enemy Amen. wants people to unalive because he knows yep. that the value of a man's soul is worth more than most of us recognize, right? So when they start that stuff, though, while that's going on, you'll get the prophet of a prophet. And at that point, I say, would you like me to call out your address? 4238, your address starts with an S. Would you like everyone to know the illegal, the abominable things, and you call yourself a pastor? Your make a pastor status is not impressing God whatsoever. If you do not repent, he will say unto you that day, depart from me, you workers of iniquity. I never knew you. I never knew you. And, you know, and sometimes you have to mute people, Mercedes, and then pray for them later. That's what I had to do this week. I had to mute them. And then pray for their liberty later, because a little leaven or leaven a whole lump. Yeah. And this is what they did to Jesus all the time. And after all, it wasn't even witches that put Jesus to the cross because they weren't even allowed in the camp.
It was his own people.
It was the church.
Mm-hmm. It was his own people.
Church, mm-hmm. Rome.
And that's what's happening now. That's what's happening now. Yeah, that's what's definitely happening now. We're going through that right now.
I straight up tell people, hey, look, I'm not a pastor. I'm not a teacher. I'm just a dude. Okay. You can follow me. You can listen to me if you want to listen to me. I'm not going to force you to do anything. I'm not here to force you to do anything. I'm here to tell you the truth. All right. If you don't like it, that's not on me.
It's also recognizing to take self off the throne.
Exactly.
See, when like, I don't even say anything to do with me. Do you know what I mean? I know my purpose and I'm going to be bold and say that. I know what I'm called to do. I know I'm called to teach. I know I'm called to be a messenger of God. I know I'm called to do many things, but I know that because it's Christ that dwells within me. Does that make sense? When you truly recognize it's Christ that dwells within you, that no longer you live any longer, but Christ lives in you, that means you recognize Jesus is the apostle, Jesus is the prophet, Jesus is the pastor, he's the shepherd, he's the teacher. So it's got nothing to do with you. When people truly have that revelation, It's got nothing to do with you. Your flesh actually starts dying and you recognize it's Christ that's manifesting the apostle. It's Christ that's manifesting the office of a prophet, an office of a teacher, an office of a pastor, an office of an evangelist. You know what I'm trying to say? Where anywhere we'd be like, oh, you know, I'm not a teacher. I'm not this. I'm not that. We limit who God is and works through us.
It's the fivefold ministry within each of us. Okay.
There you go, Wins, the fullness. Amen.
And if we allow ourselves to seek glory for that fivefold ministry that isn't our glory, God's not going to like that because it's His glory and He doesn't share His glory.
Mm. He shares His glory with His own, meaning those who are born of spirit, not born of flesh.
Exactly.
We got to make sure we get that scripture correctly because the church has defiled that enough. Because they don't recognize that God actually shares His glory with you if you are born of Him. He won't share His glory with the flesh. Well, flesh and spirit are enmity to one another.
He shares His glory with
you. I'm sorry. I feel the Holy Spirit. Woman of God.
Come on.
Woman of God, in case you don't already know, I see you. I see you. And you are called as not only an evangelist, not only are you called to the nations, not only will you flip tables, not only will you be hated by many, but honored by many.
Amen.
Hated by some, honored by many. And just remember in those days when it's the church persecuting you for righteousness, remember there be more for you than against you. And you are called as an evangelist to the nations, and you are called to tell demons to run and flee at the name of Jesus. And at His name, through your voice, people will be healed. I see people crying. I see demons screaming, leaving people. You're not even having to touch them. But because your faith has touched heaven, because of His glory, because you always make sure that all the credit, honor, and glory goes to Him and not yourself. Because in the secret place, you cry and you say, Lord, I don't want them to see me or recognize me. I want them to see and recognize you. Because what is done in secret is openly rewarded. I had to obey Him and tell you that. You are
Amen.
A healer. You are a liberator of men's souls.
Thank you, Father.
You are for the outcast.
Amen.
You are to raise up the next evangelists, the next pastors, even to bring correction to prophets and apostles to make sure the pride has to come down. And to that the humble shall be exalted. He is using you in this type of way and many other ways.
And He goes.
And He even gave you a heart for this, for the people that was that are in the sex slavery that have been tormented above comprehension and things like this. And because you have a heart for this type of mission, He's going to give you the monies because I hear that you've been praying, God, I'll do anything. I'll do anything. I'll go anywhere. Just order my footsteps and show me the way and show me how to do it, God, because I'm not educated on how to do this, God. I need destiny helpers, but I'm willing to go out, God.
Just
bring me to the right people. And He says, my daughter, I'm bringing you to the forefront. And I've connected you strategically with people that also had the same kingdom type of visions as you.
Hallelujah. Amen. Thank you, Father. Oh, thank you, Father. Yes, we give Him glory, give Him praise, and we give Him honor. Ooh, hallelujah. 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 Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Father.
Jesus.
Thank you, sister, for sharing that. Thank you. Thank you.
Oh, all the honor is His. I had to obey Him like that.
Amen. 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 And I love that you said that because the blueprint that I carry is Christ. And when I share that Jesus is the fivefold ministry, it literally demolishes, it obliterates anywhere that flesh will exalt itself, thinking like, oh, I'm an apostle, I'm a prophet, I'm a teacher, I'm this. I say that with such heaviness that I'm a teacher, I'm a prophet, I'm apostle, I'm evangelist. Do you know what I mean? Like,
all that means is we're supposed to be servants. That's not something I take lightly. That's what I was telling them yesterday. I said, you people are ignorant of what this means. Don't honor me. I said, the greatest among you is to be the greatest servant. It's about servant.
Amen.
Amen. That's what Jesus did. He came to wash feet and serve in any way that God needed him to serve. And it was through his humility that God was able to be glorified.
That's a meme.
And it's through our humility that God be glorified.
I'm going to tell you the
truth. And that's the character of Jesus Christ, is meekness, is humility.
I'm going to tell you the truth. Yes. Mercedes, this is what I tell them. I said, why do you all come against prophets? I said, the true prophets of Christ have the fear of the Lord. I said, have you all read the book? Do you have any idea what they did to all of God's prophets? Mm-hmm. I said, this title is not for Shay. It's not for Shay's recognition. It's not for Shay's glory. It means mm-hmm. I'm willing to lose my head for mm-hmm. the name of Jesus. I don't say that lightly. I fully have seen the end. I fully have seen the visions mm-hmm. of us coming on horses with swords, the great and dreadful day of the Lord. I am here to tell people, no fear what they can do to the body. Fear the one that has the power and the authority to raise the body and the soul and to put it in eternal glory or eternal damnation. There is no gray area. There's no such thing as purgatory or any of this nonsense. You are either one in Christ Jesus. You are either an heir or you are an enemy of God. Mm. There is no in between.
That's right. And
a true prophet will tell you this is a time of weeping and gnashing of teeth for the church. This is a time where the church needs to get uncomfortable. You're too comfortable. You're so lazy, he says to the church of the world.
Come on.
You're so lazy. You love your food too much. You love your own name, your own ministry. This idolatry has got to come down. This idolatry, this self-worship. Self-God worship. You're more in love with your family and your friends than me, he says. That's what he's saying. Mm. It's a time for all your brothers and sisters to put him first.
More than you honor me. Come on now.
Worshiping the creation more than the creator.
What Adam did. He worshiped the woman instead of worship God.
Yeah, you can't do that. You got to worship the creator.
Everyone's so
focused on what everybody else is doing, and it's a time for everybody to take the plank out of their own eye, and then we can maybe help somebody else. But everybody's so busybody. Everyone's so there's so much envy, and where there's envy and strife, there's every evil work. And who cares what they're doing on this side or that side? There's too many Christians being held back by their own offenses right now.
Exactly. That's something that I've been trying.
Jesus said you'll be offended.
I've been trying to point that out. I'm like, you know what? This is the only thing that's holding me back from God's blessing is you. I mean, if you actually walk with Him, He will bless you tremendously. But you've got to walk with Him. You've got to surrender your will to Him. It ain't about you. It's about Him. It's always been about Him.
Thank you, Lord. I had a pastor, Sister Mercedes. Pastor, I'm talking 200,000 views on YouTube every sermon or more to a million in America. Try to date me. Do you know this man is married? Thank God, God spoke to me. Thank God, God is a snitch. Thank God, I did not do anything at all wrong. Thank God, God will snitch. And see, and I'm telling you this only to share that, listen, in the same way what is done in secret will be openly rewarded, in the same way God is trying to reason with some His children right now, the disobedient ones. But if they do not repent, there comes a day and time when grace runs out, and He can shout it from the rooftops. And even that is his mercy. It's better to be humiliated in public on earth than it is to never be humiliated in public on earth and to stand before the great white throne dirty.
I'm going to be real. The only relationship that I want is one that's going to be, that's going to draw me closer to God. I don't want anything else. If it's not drawing me closer to God, I don't want anything to do with it.
House divided cannot stand.
That's right.
Oh, wow. Yeah. Yeah. Amen. Amen. That's just confirmation to, you know, Prophetess Shay, when you're saying about the church is lazy, you know, and I was just speaking a word on here about slothful servants. And and I was literally saying that God isn't looking for slothful servants. He's looking for servants that want to do his will, want to work just like God worked, just like Jesus worked. That means we have to work too. And all he needs is a yes. That's it. A yes from your heart and he'll do the rest. He'll take you through a pressing, a crushing, and a refining so that you can manifest more of him. More of him. More of him. And more of him.
Because that's more what of he him. Wants. That's what he wants. He wants to manifest himself through all of us. He wants to manifest himself through all of us. Not just the burning bush, not just the donkey, not just through the serpents, not through the fire. Not the wind.
That's right.
But through all of us. And all you've got to do is be a willing vessel.
That's right. Just say yes. Just say yes. Just say yes. Yes. Say yes from your soul. Say yes from your heart. Just say yes. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father.
Politics.
Yeah, because persecution is going to be even greater. I mean, it's already happening right now, guys, you know, all around the world, it's already happening right now. It's not like the way that Paul and all them had, but people are getting persecuted by just the words that they're sharing, you know. And as Prophetess Shay said, and that was confirmation of what Prophetess Shay had said, that I'll be hated by many. I mean, that's what scripture says. You know, Jesus was hated. What makes you think you're not going to be hated? If you're a true follower of Jesus Christ, you're going to be hated and you're going to be loved by those who are of God.
And that's
because they bear witness to you. And what's coming against you is the Antichrist spirit. It's those that don't know God. They don't know God. They don't love God. They love their flesh. They love their bellies. They love their lust. They love their desires. They love everything of self.
And that's what this whole community building that he's got me going through is about. It's a place where that
praise the Lord.
The teachers and the leaders of God can come back and they can get renewed through their brothers and sisters. They can get their cups refilled and go back out and do God's will. And spread his love. And spread the truth. And that's what this whole community situation is about, for me anyway.
That's beautiful. That's beautiful, because I'm praying for the same thing, Jason. I'm praying God would open up a space for me to bring the broken, to minister to the broken, to raise the broken, to equip the broken, to equip all the babes so they can step into their sonship and so they can go out and do the same. That's literally what the church is supposed to do. I'm going to be bold and say the church hasn't done it. Because all I see in churches are broken, broken, broken people that are continuously under bondage, continuously under condemnation. And you wonder why God has got us ministering on here. You wonder why God has got us being plucked out of churches. You know, because there's no love in churches. There's more religion. they're more synagogues of Satan than, you know, yeah, and they don't know it because they're under bondage. But you can't, yeah, you can lead the horse to the water, but you can't make them drink it. And at the end of the day, when you truly, when you know it's time is up, the time is up, let the dead bury the dead and keep walking on. When God tells you to release a word, you release a word. They don't hear it, they don't hear it. Dust yourself off, let the dead bury the dead and keep walking, because you've been obedient to what God called you to do, and you keep going, because yeah, God will send someone else. At the end of the day, God will send someone else. I pray God will send someone else. But we've got to keep moving. Harvest plenty. The harvest is plenty. And I come and minister on here because I'm raising up laborers. I'm raising up laborers by the teachings that the Holy Spirit has taught me. And I get to teach you guys, and then you guys get to do the same thing. You know, you get to stay firm in your walk, stand strong in who you are and whose you are. And you go out and you tell someone the same thing. You go out and say that, you know, Christ dwells within me. It's not I that live, but Christ that lives in me. You start telling the people the truth, and then the truth is going to set them free, because they're hearing, guess what? The shepherd's voice that's in you, because scripture says those who go through the gate become shepherds of the flock. Jesus is the true shepherd, and you are supposed to be shepherds that are to shepherd the flock, and you train them up, be fruitful and multiply. And that's the same thing we're doing all over again. That's the same thing that Jesus did, the same thing that we do. Jesus is the first fruit. We are the fruits of Jesus Christ, and we are to be fruitful and multiply more fruits of Jesus Christ. Amen. That's why I have such a passion for sound doctrine, because people aren't hearing sound doctrine. Amen?
No, they're not. Yes, they're not. Yes. And if you can't,
Love you. Sorry, love you, Prophetess Shay. God bless you.
Oh, sorry. And my sister, this keeps dropping on in my heart to say that when Jesus says, pick up your cross and carry it, he said, pick up your church. You, the church, pick it up, carry it, move forward.
Yes, carry the church. Yeah, amen.
Yes, pick up your church and move forward. Yes.
Well, I mean, because the church died and then the church arised. Hallelujah.
Yes, praise God. Amen. Which is our temple. We are the church.
Mm-hmm. We are the church. And when God
We are the church. Not when, a structural building. Structural building is not a church.
When God gives you heart to tear after, and people to tear after, and he shows you who those people are. You don't ignore that. You can't ignore that, because it is his.
Amen. Amen. Yeah, guys, I don't just come on here. Can you hear me? I don't just come on here for fun. I come on here to work. Do you know what I mean? I come on here to work. I come on here to teach. I come on here to minister. I come on here to dismantle some false deception, lying, cunning snakes that have come in and deceived you, come and put scales over your eyes, whatever it is. I come and literally deliver God's people when he tells me to come and deliver people, because what I speak delivers you, whether you recognize it or not. When I speak truth, it shall set you free. It shall set you free from that deception. It shall set you free from that pride. It shall set you free from those scales. It will set you free. Because why? I set myself apart. Why? Because I work out my own salvation with fear and trembling. Why? Because I'm continuously short account with my Father, and I make sure that my eye gates are clean, my ear gates are clean, my mouth gates are clean, my gates are clean. So every time that when I speak, he can go straight through me and speak to his children. That's how we're supposed to be. That's a walk in Christ. Amen?
It is a walk in Christ.
That's how we're supposed to be. Mm-hmm.
We all have our different method, but it's all through God. It's all from God.
Well, as long as you're building them up, that's all that matters. And as long as they're staying firm in their walk, that's all that matters. And at the end of the day, it's the fruits will speak for itself. The fruits is going to speak for those who are ministering to you. And if you're listening to someone that's like, your fruits aren't even, like, you're not even manifesting meekness, you're not even manifesting gentleness, you ain't even manifesting the love of Christ, you ain't even manifesting patience, kindness, long suffering, then it's not of God. You're eating from the knowledge of good and evil. You ain't eating from the tree of life, because the tree of life is what's going to keep you in freedom. The tree of life is what's going to give you eternal life.
Mercedes, you kind of know me fairly well. You know some of my story. But I'll straight up tell people, you know what? You don't mess with Jesus, and you don't mess with my family. And my family is all of you. Okay? And somebody is messing with you, you come to me, and God will shut them down. Straight up. Because he's not one to mess with at all.
Praise the Lord.
Anyway, I'm going to bounce. But, I love you.
Oh, bless you. Love you too, Jason. Thank you for sharing. God bless you. But yeah, I agree. Yeah, I'm in complete agreement. Guys, we've got to start being more protective of the flock. Also being protective of yourselves. And what I mean by that is just being disciplined in your walk. Just making sure who you're eating with. Making sure who you're listening to. Making sure that... is what that person is saying, is what Mercedes saying, you know, are you bearing witness to what I'm speaking, you know, is what I'm saying of the word of God. Do you know what I'm trying to say, guys? And sometimes, thank you, Father, the Holy Spirit, brothers and sisters, is just to bring things to remembrance of what God's been already saying to you. And then you hear it by the Holy Spirit, and you're like, oh, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. And the Holy Spirit is to keep us. It's just to keep us firm, steadfast in our walk. Me, when I speak, it's to keep you steadfast in your walk. When Wen speaks, when Trelease speaks, when we all should speak and we're really keeping ourselves from unclean things, it should be continuously, we should be continuously just keeping each other short account. You know, if I said something that wasn't of God, I pray that Wen's would tell me. I pray that Trelease would tell me. Do you know what I'm trying to say? Like, we've got to be able to trust each other enough to correct each other in love. And if you can truly see the motive and the intention, that you know that their heart, they're pure of coming to you and correcting you. And also have mercy and grace for those that correct you, truly. Because it's not easy, guys. It's not easy. But you know what? When God tells you to do it, you do it. Amen? So have mercy and grace for those that bring rebuke to the body of Christ. Have mercy and grace that bring, you know, correction to the body of Christ. Have mercy and grace for them, because it's not easy. And they're not just sitting there being slothful servants and just, you know, getting a word from God and then they start speaking to you. No, no, absolutely not. We get pressed, we get crushed, and we get refined to bring forth this word that's to set you free. It's death to self that brings forth the word of God to set his children free. You know, and Wentz could bear witness to that. Trelease can bear witness to that. You know, that they're in their season. We're all in a season. We're all getting pressed. We're all getting crushed. We're all getting refined. And if you haven't been, well, good luck. It's coming. It's coming. Yeah, go, sister.
Oh, I was just sitting.
Oh, praise God. Come on, share with us.
I don't know, I feel like I have been lazy. I can admit that.
Go. Well, okay, well, can you express to us, what do you mean by it? How has the Lord convicted you? Where have you been lazy? Because maybe something that you're going to say is going to set 12 people free. Who knows?
With, eating a lot.
Okay.
Like just eating food and just not spending time, using my time wisely with the Lord and not spending, waking up and praying, just waking up and talking to the Lord first, but going on my phone.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Yeah, we've all done that. We all do that every now and then. It's just remembering, Lord, turn your phone off and start praying. Yeah, because that's us giving our fruits to devices. we're not giving our first fruit to God.
Amen.
I'm speaking from experience. Amen. Mm-hmm.
And just making.
But I even remember that. Yeah, making him second.
Making the Lord your Lord of your life. You know, like as the bro was saying, like just really like making sure that the Lord is first in your life.
Mm-hmm. Gotta be.
Yeah.
Gotta be. Even in the way you speak, he's gotta be first in your life. Because if you speak from your flesh, you're serving the flesh. You're not serving God. Amen? Amen. Hmm. Thank you, Lord. Hello, Debbie. God bless you.
Blessings, sister. Blessings. I want to let you know what... I want to let you know what the Lord's been telling me about the lives on here. We have to be careful on what live we go on. And the Lord has been backing me out of a lot of lives on this thing.
Good.
Like the lives that we go on, and all they do is say, tap, 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 tap. Give me those gifts. Give me those gifts. That offended me. No, we are not on here for the gifts.
Mm-mm.
Do you know?
If you want to share, then, I mean.
Oh, my Lord.
If you want to sow, then sow. But, yeah, absolutely. Yes. Amen.
Okay, I was a giver with the gifts, okay? And I didn't realize how much it was costing me. I would do the 29 cent ones because, okay, it's only 29 cents. Well, those 29 cents add up. And my account is not in my name. I'm not the one paying for it. My older son is, because my phone is a gift from my son for Christmas many years ago, and he pays for it still. And I told him, I said, well, can you get it so that I can pay for whatever I buy on the phone? And he said, you can't. He said, it's a family plan, and he has like 7 different people on his plan. Sister, praise the Lord. My son said, Ma, your TikTok came up to $24. So then I paid him for it, you know, with the Apple Pay. And then I'm getting more because I'm a giver. Aren't we givers? Don't we want to give those gifts and make somebody feel good? So I kept
giving. It's also having discernment.
Oh, Lord, another $24. I spent like almost $50 in 1 month. And the Lord was saying, do you know you could have paid a bill with that? You could have paid a bill with that. And the Lord said, no more. Stop. Stop.
Cold but what you sow in.
Oh, sorry, my sister. I just wanted to tell Debbie that she needs to also be careful where she sows in. She needs to sow.
Yeah, I was literally about to say that.
Yeah, she needs to sow.
What you sow is what you reap.
Yes, yes. Most definitely. So he told me, he said, stop. So I cannot, all I can do is give the rest of the gifts that I already paid
for. So you've been wasting it on flesh, basically. That's what you've been doing. You've been wasting your gifts on flesh.
No more. And the Lord is so, he's so awesome because he doesn't condemn us. He convicts us.
And I'm going to say this in a huge rebuke and in so much love. And this is not towards you, Debbie. And I understand this because I've done this too, but. Holy Spirit, do you know, brothers and sisters, that I see more people sowing more into those who are of the flesh than those who are of the kingdom?
Yes.
See, and that's what Wenz is saying as well. I'm very, very discerning of who I sow into. I won't sow into everyone. I'll sow into Wenz if she's on alive, because I know she's a kingdom of God. And where I sow is what I'm going to reap, right? And so I'm going to reap heavenly things. I'm not going to reap fleshly things. Do you know what I mean? I'll sow into Trelease because I know that God is taking her through a process. So it's being discerning of where you sow. Just like Wenz was saying, if you're sowing into dead ground, you know what I mean? You're not reaping anything from the kingdom. That's you're reaping things of the flesh. Yeah. And so It makes me so righteously angry that people so into all these people that are like, give me gifts, tap, you know, tap the screen, give me gifts. But you got people, and I'm going to say this in so much love, you got people working their butts off, getting pressed, getting crushed, getting refined to bring forth revelations for you, and you can't even sow into them? That's disgusting. That's absolute disgust. And I'm saying that in a big rebuke of the body of Christ in general. I'm rebuking every person on here. Where you have sowed into the flesh, woe unto you.
Yes. You know what that reminds me of? It reminds
Start
me of
sowing into the kingdom of God.
That go to the sports games. Yay, yay, yay. And they're clapping and jumping up and down. What are we doing for the Lord? Not us personally, but what are God's people doing for him? Are we yaying him? Are we cheering him on? Hallelujah. I just had to let you know about that because that just happened yesterday. But I'm so thankful. I'm so thankful that the Lord speaks to us. No more, he said.
The devil is mad. My phone isn't charging. Get off in Jesus' name.
It was my big sister.
Oh, so my goodness.
Last year, I had $100 on TikTok.
Keep going.
And I was sewing into...
air con this car.
I was sewing into, like, the flip.
You're breaking up. Boy, is the devil mad. He does not want us talking about this. I can't hear anything. Amen. Jason, I'm praying for you. Hallelujah. No weapon formed against you shall prosper. Bad connection.
Can you guys hear me?
Yes, now I can.
Can you hear me?
Yes. You're breaking up pretty bad, though.
Yeah, I'm just... my phone. My phone is hot.
Yeah, maybe you better take a break and let it cool down.
You guys hear me?
Yes, we do.
Stop freezing in the name of Jesus.
Amen. I'm in agreement with you. Enough is enough. Stop.
Stop.
Still freezing up.
See.
They went out. I was sewing into dead contents. If you guys,
can you guys hear me?
Yay! Praise the Lord.
Did you guys hear me? Okay.
Praise God.
You know. Praise God.
Oh, glory. You're breaking up. Stop breaking up in the name of Jesus.
Really, just Rex. Can you guys? Can you get? Are you guys hearing me now?
Yeah. Okay. Yes. Now yes. It's good.
Okay. Perfect.
Stay good in Jesus' name.
Awesome. Amen. Amen. Yeah. We've got to be able to have discernment. We've got to be able to have discernment who is of the kingdom of God. And I said this before, even before Debbie came on here, but you've got to recognize, brothers and sisters, not everyone is in the kingdom of God. Mm-hmm. Really receive that. Not everyone is in the kingdom of God. Not everyone. Not everyone is in the kingdom of God. And so you've got to recognize who's of the kingdom of God and who's of the kingdom of darkness. And when you know that there's some lump in there that's really defiling everything, you don't sow into that. Mm-mm. You don't sow into that ground. But you can sow this way. You can sow by your words, but don't sow by finances and all that stuff. Sow this way, and if they rebuke you or whatever, then you let the dead bury the dead and keep walking.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
Mm-hmm. Amen. Mercedes, should we sell everything we have and give it to the poor? Yeah, hey, if God leads you, do it. If God told me to sell everything, I sell everything. I have everything. I don't need nothing. I got Jesus. Jesus is my everything.
Amen.
Amen.
Yeah, it's not ours anyways.
If we don't have Jesus, we have nothing.
But it is like, yeah, that's right. That's right. Mm-hmm. So praise God. Praise God, guys. All I was just saying before, I don't know if you guys heard me, but you've got to be discerning of who you're sowing into. And you've got to recognize when that foundation has become messy. That foundation, you know what I mean? You got to recognize when that foundation has spiritually died. And so you don't be sowing into that. You can sow by your words, decree, declare life over them. Pray that God will remove the scales and the pride and uproot any bitterness, resentment, whatever it is. Wherever the devil has come and sowed tares in their field, you just pray for them. But that's when you recognize you have discernment. You'll be like, I can't sow into that because that's not a good ground. But I can speak life into that ground.
Mm-hmm. My sister, I've got a little story. I was on someone's live. Last year. It's quite a while.
Mm-hmm.
And this guy came on and they'd done a deliverance. They wanted to do a deliverance on him because he had he had encounters with evil spirits. And on this live they discovered that he actually sowed into a false preacher. And what the preacher done was take his money and use it as sacrifices on altars.
Oh.
So it's so important for us to know what we sow in, and we need to test the spirit, not the flesh. We need to test the spirit.
Oh, thank you, Lord.
Yeah, Lord. Yeah, Lord, in confession right now, Lord, where I've sowed into like dead ground. Oh, Lord. Amen. Lord, confessing before my brothers and sisters where I've sowed into dead ground, Lord. I know I've sowed into like celebrities and all that jazz, Lord, that have been on here and, you know, asking for gifts. And I was just, very lack of understanding at that time. But
I thank you, God, for the revelations. I thank you, God, for the testimony, Lord. And Lord, I, in the act of my own will, Lord, I repent. I repent for anywhere I have sowed, Lord, where I've sowed and it has been sacrifices unto devils. Lord, I repent right now. Ooh, I renounce all contract with anywhere that I've sowed into dead ground, Lord. I renounce all contract right now in the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus, I
renounce. In the name of Jesus. Ooh. Deal Jesus. With me, Father.
Hallelujah.
Send your fire upon us right now. Purge us. Press us.
Yes, Lord.
Whatever you got to do, Lord, I receive your judgment right now. Holy Spirit, come and burn the dross, the chaff, the wind in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Lord. Whoa.
Thank you, Jesus.
Ooh.
Ooh. Another thing that thank the you, Lord has me doing is I used to get on the lives in the chat room. I wouldn't get up in the box, but I'd listen to them argue.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, once saved, always saved. The Trinity.
Oh yeah, no, that's Discord.
Do you know that's another thing?
That's Discord,
because that's Discord. That's trying to separate the body. That's causing confusion. And you know, when after you hear all that garbage, you feel like garbage. So I mean, I don't get on there anymore either, because that's not uplifting, is it? It's not uplifting at all. It's tearing you down.
That's not of God. It's actually killing your soul. It's actually making your soul sick listening to things like that.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And God doesn't want us doing that, you know. And some people
it's
get
killing
so
your soul.
So angry about it, you know, and their point of view that it's terrible. So I stopped doing those, you know, listening to those. Too much drama and drama. That's another thing. Even people that are having drama. Oh boy, that's or talking about people, getting on a live and talking about people. They don't even know if that person's on the outside listening in. Shame on them. Shame on them. Oh. Okay.
So that's accuser of the brethren.
Yes.
We've all done that. I can confess on that, and I've already repented on that, but that's accusing of the brethren. And it's just unhealed issues in our hearts when we start speaking that way.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, I just learned to just pray for them, give them over to God. That's all you can do.
Yes.
That's all you can do. And I don't know if you've been on here, Debbie, when I've spoken this, but this is why I'm so vigilant when it comes to teachings of the trees of knowledge of good and evil and the tree of life. See, what you were eating, Debbie, in that was tree of knowledge of good and evil.
Mm-hmm.
And what you didn't recognize is that was killing every fruit in you and killing your soul, killing your body, and killing your spirit. Yeah.
Yep.
Well, that's why I speak on the teachings that I teach, because it brings revelation to people to not be ignorant to the enemy's devices.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Mm. And how amazing is that? God has allowed you to go through that so you can have wisdom, knowledge, and understanding why you shouldn't be eating at tables like that, because those tables are lifted up to the devil. They're not lifted up to God.
Right.
Mm-mm. Mm-mm. Mm-hmm. Nowhere whatsoever does that table glorify God. Nowhere whatsoever does it glorify God where we sow discord, disunity, and backbite one another. Absolutely not.
Well, condemning.
Yeah, that's the same thing.
I had one like that last year. This guy was like, I had $100 in my TikTok balance.
Mm-hmm.
And like, I kept sowing. Lord, I just repent from it. I kept sowing into him, but he was actually like condemning me to do it. Like, no, I was like being condemned actually by the enemy, not but anyways.
Yeah, because we don't wrestle against flesh and blood. I get it.
Yeah, not him. Thank you, Lord. Lord, what was I gonna say?
You had $100 and you were sowing into him.
Mm-hmm.
Oh yeah, and it was about he was expecting us to pay for his kid because he lost his job apparently, and then we had to pay him money to supply for his kid's birthday party and stuff.
That's another thing.
Sad.
Giving people money.
Scammers.
I'm not doing that anymore either, because, you know, I was moved by my emotions, you know.
That's
someone's
right,
living in the car. They're living in the car. They're cold. They're hungry. As it is, I have a my son friend that used to come over. He's like a son. He's homeless right now. Now I bought him out to lunch. We talked. He's saved, but he has been going through hell on the streets. He just had three guys come up to him and hit him in the head with a bat. And he said, Ma, he calls me Ma because I'm like his Ma. His mother died and he's looking for his father. He doesn't know where his father is. But, you know, he said, Ma, he said, I couldn't help it. He said, I beat him up. He said, I'm afraid I'm going to go to jail. He said, I messed him up real bad, Ma. I feel real bad. I said, he said, was I wrong for doing that? I said, you were protecting yourself. No, you weren't. You got to be careful on the main streets, go on the back roads. He's afraid the cops were looking for him. So he's going to church with me today. So I praise God, and he's so excited. He is so excited. And I know that God's plans for him are going to change his life, you know. He was shot in the head. He's paralyzed.
Wow.
He's looking for a job, and it's hard because he's paralyzed. But you know what? I know God's going to make a way for him. God's going to make a way. I prayed for his body to be healed, and he's going to come to my church, and I know God has some great things. I'm just so excited. So excited. Hallelujah.
Wow. That's amazing. Praise the Lord. God, move powerfully. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Yeah, amen, Wens. We pray for deliverance on his life. Hallelujah. Yeah. Oh, I just want to agree with what Wens was saying too, is, you know, guys, when we sow into what Wens was saying, when we sow what we sow, we come in agreement with that spirit behind. You know, and so that's, yeah, that's, yeah. When you don't have discernment, then that can really mess you up. But I heard the Lord saying, when you bless those who are sowing in the kingdom, when you bless someone that you know is in the kingdom, you get blessed too. So if you're blessing someone that's not in the kingdom of God, well, you're blessing the devil.
Yep.
You ain't blessing God. No, ma'am. You're actually building, you're building your own kingdom. You're not building the kingdom of God. And so that's like for me.
Amen.
I'm that very, foundation. Very. Amen. That's right. And I'm very specific of who I sow into. 100%. Because not everyone's of Christ.
Right.
Not everyone are my brothers and sisters either. I mean, that's scripture. If we're studying ourselves, approved.
I just have to say this.
But you sow into the fruits. Yeah.
Like, but there's like obviously a difference between like giving money, like giving money to like the poor, eh?
So when it says like, God literally means, he doesn't mean the poor, because obviously the Bible is spiritual. He means those who are spiritually poor.
Yeah.
You know? But yes, money, you can sow into those that are needed, absolutely. Especially those who are feeding the, like, the orphans, the widows, you know, 100%. Yeah. But at the end of the day, it's all being led by the Lord. That's really what it comes down to.
Amen.
Amen. It is like 2 hours and 40 minutes. I love you guys, but I'm out. If you guys have anything to share before I go, praise the Lord. I mean, I love you, but honestly, I've sowed 2 hours and 40 minutes into you guys, literally. And so I love you too. You know, and I say that, you know, with such cheerfulness, because whatever God has ministered through me has delivered you, has set you free, has healed you, has ministered to you, and that's all I can ask for, is the Father to use me as a vessel to speak to his children.
Amen. I couldn't do a
long
live like that.
I love it. I honestly, Debbie, like, I thrive on sharing the word of God. Thrive on, especially because I know that no one, like, my foundations became rocky when I started listening to man. Mm-hmm. And because I know that I'm so connected to the Lord, I know that when I speak, it's God that speaks through me, you know, and obviously I get people to test the spirits. I want you guys to test me because I know I'm from God. You got to recognize I'm from God. Like, mm-hmm. you know, I know Trelease and Wins and Debbie are from God, but you got to recognize. Do you know what I'm trying to say? Mm-hmm. Like, we've got to keep ourselves short account with one another. We've got to make sure that, okay, are you testing the spirits? Oh, that live, you know, I I've done this with Crystal too. God will literally get me to go and minister to Crystal when she was in a live that she wasn't supposed to be in. Does that make sense?
Yes,
that's how much God loves his children.
Yes.
So when I come across someone and I see they're in a live, and the Lord will say, speak to them. And I was like, okay, yep, Lord. And I do it. Mm-hmm. And if they feel offended, they get offended. Well, big whoop. Take it up with God. You know, I only just came to help, but no worries. You can get eaten up by the seducing spirits, your choice. But at the end of the day, I've done what God called me to do. I spoke it and said, you know, the Spirit of the Lord has led me to speak to you. You shouldn't be in that life. It's not lifting up life. It's lifting up discord, disunity, bitterness, resentment, anger, blah, blah, blah. Test the spirits. That's what you're called to do. And I'll leave it at that. Some people have gotten bitter and resentful of me even saying that to them. And it really hurts my heart, and I'm saying this in love, guys. I had people that ate with me spiritually, and then I find them at carnal lives. Do you know how much that grieves me, which I know grieves God's heart? Because they started off in the spirit, and what, they think they've been made perfect in the flesh?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, foolish. Oh, foolish, foolish Galatians. Mm-hmm. And it hurts my heart. But then I go and I go and correct them in love, and I say, like, you know, I'm really seeing some pride arise in you or something like that. They don't like that. The pride in them just, I was like, okay, Lord, I give them
like
to
nobody's
you.
Nobody's going to tell me what to do.
Dust myself off and walk.
Attitude.
Yeah, but they can't see that the motive and the intention of my heart was to come because the Spirit of the Lord literally led me to you and to speak to you. And even have mercy and grace for people that do that. I literally said that before anyways. Mm-hmm. Have mercy and grace for those that come and correct you. Because it's not easy, guys. It's dying to the flesh, isn't it, Wens? Yeah. It's dying to the flesh. Mm-hmm. It's literally dying to the flesh. Like, you don't want to go correct someone. Your flesh does not want to go and correct someone. Right. But you're going to be obedient because your soul is saying no to the flesh and saying yes to the spirit. I'm going to do what the spirit told me to do. Because what? Jesus did the same thing. He didn't bow down to the sinful nature, which is the flesh. He bowed down to Christ. He bowed down to God. And he did what God told him to do, and that's it.
Amen. Amen.
But in that note, thank you, Father, because I did say sinful nature. We've got to recognize, guys, that we no longer wear the sinful nature. Like, if I could just be bold and beautiful, hallelujah, be bold and say that to you. When Jesus died on the cross, you died with him. When Jesus rose from the dead, you rose with him. But you're walking it out. Because if you don't truly have that understanding, then you've got to just wait unto the Lord and make him reveal it to you. But I'm going to release revelations to you because it's time. Because these revelations are going to help you to grow into your sonship. It's going to help you to grow into your authority. It's going to help you to grow into that there's greater things. There's greater things ahead. There's greater things ahead, which is recognizing the glory that is to be revealed in you, which is Christ. Paul's a perfect example of that. He says, I tarried again until Christ was formed.
Amen. That's why I don't like to hear, I'm just a sinner saved by grace. We're not sinners.
Hallelujah. We have been made righteous.
We are the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. Hallelujah.
That's right. We've overcome what? By the blood of the Lamb and the word of our testimony. Now, if you haven't overcome by the blood of the Lamb or the word of your testimony, then you're dead letter. You're still spiritually dead. You're still dead in Jesus. You haven't risen from the dead with Jesus. But you've got to have that revelation too, that you've died with Christ. you've risen with Christ. And at the end of the day, if you don't have revelations of Jesus Christ, you're a dead letter.
Yep.
Straight up. I'll be bold to say that. I love you enough to tell you the truth.
Mm-hmm. Amen. Mm-hmm. Amen. And my sister, the fact that they move from your life to another life, is that not also proof that they do not know the shepherd's voice?
Yes.
I only saw in your life.
But they've become deceived too. See, if there's unhealed issues, sister, in their hearts, do you know what I mean? They're gonna be deceived by the voice. They're gonna hear the familiar voice than the shepherd's voice. And they're gonna think that they're hearing the shepherd's voice, but they're hearing the familiar voice, which is the stranger's voice. Because if you haven't gone through delivering of all the parts in your souls, you know, because it's a work, it's a process.
Yes.
Yes. But I know this because, you know, even though I know the shepherd's voice, right? I became an accuser of the brethren. And I'm going to say that in love. I have no shame. Man, the devil is like angry right now that I just tell everything. I'm like, I met a man named Jesus who told me everything about me. Do you know what I mean? I don't care. Like, I'm that Samaritan woman. I'm that woman running around. Like, guys, I want to tell you, like, I was an accuser of the brethren and Jesus told me. Do you know what I mean? Like, I was. And I know the shepherd's voice. But the Lord showed me because of wherever I decide to eat or a leadership I came under or whatever, it deceived me. And then I started eating what that, you know, without, yeah, just layers and layers of revelations and layers of growing and stepping into more of his fullness. I know the shepherd's voice, but because there was stuff in me where I was feeling rejected and, like, you know, people were just like persecuting me and all that jazz, it started hardening my heart, and I hardened my heart towards them, you know, and I started like being accused of the brethren, even though it was still God, like he was speaking to me, but the way I went about it wasn't of God. Mm-hmm. It was where I had unhealed issues in my heart to deal with, and I praise God for allowing that. He allowed that so he could minister to me more, and I'm never going to do that again, am I? I'm not going to go and accuse another brethren, because I already went through my judgment. I already went through my rebuke from my father, and I love my father enough to not do that again. So everything that we're going through is to bring glory to God. It's not onto death. It's onto the glory of God. And these ones that have left my table and gone and eat at carnal tables, it actually just shows that they're being seduced by seducing spirits. And then what has God done? He's given them over to a reprobate mind, because now they've gone after the lust of their own eyes, the lust of their flesh, and the pride of life. The knowledge of good and evil has been resurrected in them when they were made perfect by the Spirit.
Mercedes, I'm out of gifts, and I gave my last gifts to you.
Oh, damn it, if you have to. Bless you. You're going to be blessed.
Good ground. Good ground.
Amen. You're going to be blessed. Every person that's sowed into Mercy Ministry, you're all going to be blessed. I know that, because my ground is good ground, guys. Amen. I get pressed and crushed and refined for this ground. But, and, you know, so is Wen, so is Debbie, so is Trelease, and we're all going through a process, but... Amen. You know, so I just bless, I bless your seeds. Debbie, I bless every person that has sowed into this kingdom, because you're sowing, when you sow into me, and I say this, when you sow into me, you sow into the kingdom of God.
Amen.
And so you're going to be blessed. You're going to be now blessed.
Do you have
in abundantly.
A Cash App or PayPal or something? I don't know if you put that up there.
Yeah, it's on my TikTok.
Okay. Okay. So yeah, when I'm led by the Lord, that's one thing I'm obedient in, is when the Lord tells me to give money. I'm very obedient in that. So pray the Lord.
Praise God. Praise God. And yeah, you know, even if you can't sow, please pray for me. I'm literally definitely. Like, brothers and sisters, I'm praying for God to give me a space. Like, when my heart goes out for the broken, and I'm just like, Lord, I need a space. Like, I've had brothers and sisters that are getting attacked in their own homes and stuff. Like, I just want to be a space for them that they can come and I can minister to, like I'm doing here. Amen. Do you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. And sometimes they just need that. They need that wilderness. They need to be taken over into the wilderness and be covered and protected and fed in that. And so I'm really praying for the Lord to send me a space. Send me to a space that I can bring his children and minister to them, because a lot of them are just broken and they haven't been shown the right way. They haven't been shown the foundations, the true foundation of Jesus Christ. And so guess what? Their foundations have been built on sand, and all the trials and the tribulations that they're getting, they're all falling. They're all falling. They're getting whacked in the spirit because their foundation wasn't built on Jesus. It was built on man. Do you know how much that grieves my heart? And so I'm like, Lord, and he knows my heart. And I know there's a space coming. I know it's coming. Because I don't know when he's sending me to America, but he's sending me. But if until then, he needs to open up a space for me here to minister to souls, I'm going to do it. Lord, send
me. Where are you?
Send me, oh God. I'm in Melbourne, in Australia.
Oh, okay.
Hmm.
So you want to come over here to America?
So the Lord's sending me to America. He gave me that word last year.
Strong in my spirit. Mm. I feel like a couple of months, something's really going to start moving for you.
Oh, come on. Ooh.
Yeah, I feel it. I feel it really strong. And you know,
come on, God, Lord. Hallelujah.
He's going to have it step after step. Everything's going to fall right into place. I see it. It's beautiful.
Amen. It's beautiful. Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. Hi, Jakari. I miss you too. I love you. It's so good to see you here. Oh, I love seeing my brothers and sisters. Amen, Debbie. I receive that. I receive that humbly. Amen. Thank you, Father. I just want a space to take his broken in and just love them. Love them into healing. Love them into restoration, and then send them back out and do the same thing. You know Amen. What I mean? That's all we're supposed Amen. To do. We're just supposed to love them until they've been restored and then send them back out.
Amen.
My heart is so like tender, guys. My heart is so tender for souls. So tender for those that have been following blind shepherds and leading them into ditches.
That's a desire that he's placed on your heart, because it's not there by mistake. He's put it there for a reason, and it's a huge desire that you have, is because this is what he wants to fulfill.
Amen. Yes, this is Lord, what he wants come to on.
Oh, yes.
Yes, Lord. Amen. Amen, sister. So, you know, guys, if you can't sow financially, your prayers are powerful enough. Do you know what I mean? So just, whenever the Lord leads you, just lift me up in prayer. I'm getting like whacked in the spirit, honestly, but praise God. Praise God. You know, he wouldn't be coming hard for us if he didn't know there was something so precious in us. Do you know what I mean?
Yes.
Yes, Jakari. I'll come back later. I'll come back later. I will come back later. The Lord will most likely lead me back on here. But I'm not tired. Like for me, it's just, I could chat to the cows come home. Do you know what I mean? I also am aware of my surroundings. I'm also aware that God's not only getting me to sow into you guys, I'm even sowing into unbelievers right now. So
Amen.
My heart is for the outcast, like Prophetess Shay said. I have a heart for the outcast. I do. Mm-hmm. Oh, I do. Oh, I do. Honestly, and I'm going to cry because I do. I have a heart for those that have been cast aside, those that have been taught religion and have not been taught intimacy, have not been taught the true foundations of Jesus Christ. I have a heart for them. And so I'm mindful of that because God's got me sowing into like raising people up who are, thank you, Father. Oh, my goodness. And he's just saying to me, well, my daughter, I sent you to people to train them up, but they didn't want to be trained. And so what do? You go out to the highways and the byways, and I'm going to send you to people that want to eat from me. I'm going to send you to people that want to, you know, want to know me, want to eat from me. Oh, man.
Amen.
I'm not going to send you to people that want to continuously make excuses, because why? Because we're done. God's done with serving up his pearls to swines. He's not going to keep throwing his pearls to swines.
Yep.
Yeah.
Time to move on. Hallelujah.
Yeah, if it's a dead foundation, keep moving on. Yep. Amen. Amen, Jakari. It's time to move on. And so, honestly, I was sowing into a foundation that continuously, this is what happened. I sowed into people and then they kept going under bondage, and I kept sowing into them and they kept going under bondage. And that's what, the frustration God would feel. He gets you to sow into his children and then they go back under bondage. Sow into them, go under bondage. Yep. So they've got to come to the revelation that they're under bondage.
Right.
So then I got to use my oil and go and give it to people that want to drink it and want to restore them and go out and restore others, not want to put them back under bondage. Amen.
Right.
So, you know, and maybe that's bold to say, but honestly, guys, I'm done. I'm done with slothful servants. Mm-hmm. I'm done with just continuously giving myself to everything that. It's end of the day, it's the spirit that's going to reveal it to them. And right now, the foundations are a bit, how's it going? So God will do what he will do, because I think about what he did with me when I was under bondage. Mm-hmm. And look at where I am now.
Yep.
You know, so there's hope. There's always hope in Jesus Christ. We know we may not be seeing it because, well, we've plowed as much as what God has called us to plow. Now we move on.
Yep.
But thank you, Father. But nothing is ever a waste. And we know that, right? But I just felt to really say this. Nothing is ever a waste, because you have been obedient. And though you've spoken it, right? You've sowed it. When their heart has become tender, guess what's going to happen? All those words that you've sowed into them is going to drop.
Amen.
It's no competition. We're all going to the same kingdom. And
yes, you make me think of that scripture.
Yeah.
Do not be weary in well doing.
Yes. Amen. He says that a lot to me.
Yep.
He says that a lot to me. And I do though. And you know, Father says that because we do, guys. We get so weary in well doing, because if we don't see something happening in the physical, but we don't recognize, man, we're sowing hardcore in the spirit. Mm-hmm. Our words being spoken, like without people recognizing, and maybe they do recognize, but I've sowed mightily into the spirit right now. And the Lord's just, and I don't need to worry about where it falls now, because what? The Father brings the increase.
Amen.
He brings the water. He waters the seed and he brings the increase. I speak the word. He waters it and increases it.
It happens in the heavenlies first, and then it comes in the natural. So just because you say something, you don't see it in the natural. It already happened in the heavenlies as soon as you spoke it. Hallelujah.
It's just a warfare in the in the heavenlies.
Yes.
Yeah, amen. Yes. Jakari, there is a place for you in America. I believe in Dallas, Texas. Upper Room is a great church. Pray. Okay. Thank you, Jakari. I will. I will, Lord. Hallelujah. So we keep doing it. Amen. We keep pressing in, brothers and sisters. We just keep pressing in. We keep pressing in, because nothing is ever a waste. Nothing is ever a waste. We just keep pressing in. So I'll be back later, guys. I love you all so much. Now I got to go and sow into other people, but I've sowed here. Praise the Lord. God's doing what he's doing here. And I love all of you so much. I love you, Debbie. I love you, Wens. I love you. Chalice. I love you, Jakari. I love you, Kylie. I love you, Stephen, Athena, Tishbo. I love you all. I love 11 people under my voice. I will be back later. So be on later and let's eat together again. Amen.
Amen.
May the Lord bless you, keep you, make his face shine upon you, and be gracious to every one of you until I see you again. Bye.
Amen. Blessings, everyone.
Bye. Thank you for the gifts. Thank you for the gifts. God bless.
Be blessed, everyone.
Bye. You too. Bye. Bye, Wins. I love you so much.